Kyle Lugs here with the Savannah Bananas in Kansas City, Kansas. We are here for the first ever Bananas Mukbang. I'm joined by my co-host, Dan Oberst. We've got some barbecue.
Absolutely.
I'm going to tell you first off the jump, I'm not going to eat any of those baked beans.
Why?
I'm not a big beans guy. They kind of scare me. I don't think I've ever had them.
Try it. Let me give you some. I don't like that. Just no.
Will you give them to me? I just want to try them.
You gotta stop looking at me, bro. Okay.
2 out of 10.
Hold on. On three?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. Mmm. Wow. I just swallowed it. Barely.
You swallowed that like a bill. You played yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
3-2 loss.
Mm-hmm. That's good.
Mm-hmm.
Ah! Ghost will get you.
Mm-hmm.
Let me get another one of these burnt ends real quick.
So the game we played yesterday, we lost 3-2.
Yep.
First inning did not go our way.
No.
At all. We'll move to the second inning. Mm-hmm. They got a good little squad over there.
Yeah.
I thought it was super cool to see them. I kind of like their take on it. It's hot in here.
Mac and cheese. Oh my God. At this point, it's only right.
Once again, I
I'm gonna die.
Good steak and brisket. One of my favorite things from the game last night was the post-game meal.
Slaw?
And that being the cheese corn.
Go ahead, get in there.
Art. There you go. Oh, you can do it. Mm-hmm. Mm. Pretty good, right?
A little messy.
Mm-hmm. Took my hand off with those chompers.
Wow!
Pretty good.
Wow!
There. Yeah. Good texture, good smoke ring. You don't get as much as I am. Good bread.
Help me out here.
can do.
Brisket?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. Wow!
Better the second time around. Well, it's been a blast.
Mm-hmm.
This is
wow!
This is going to be all from the first ever Savannah Bananas Mukbang. We'll see you guys next time. There probably won't be a next time.
See ya! Wow. Big thank you to Kyle Lewigs and Dan Oberst for 4 minutes of pure laughter there. This is the 14th and final game on the Banana Ball World Tour. And of course, as you could see by the great barbecue here in the Midwest, we are live in Kansas City, Kansas. You are looking through our eye in the sky. Legends Field, home of the Kansas City Monarchs. This is night two of the Bananas taking on the Monarchs in the first ever professional matchup of Banana Ball, where the Nanners have taken on opponents outside of the friendly Savannah Bananas umbrella. As you can see, it is rocking here in KC. The crowd outside, absolutely mad. It's actually the first time in Bananas history that they tried to storm the gates. I think it was advertised 5:30 gates open. We decide, let's push to 5:45. It'll make the show a little more exciting. And right at 5:30, the folks came storming on in. We had to hold them off. So they got the proper parade and welcome. that we wanted them to get. Welcome inside the broadcast booth. Biko Scala here. So very excited to bring you the final game of the Banana Ball World Tour. It is very bittersweet to come to the end of the road here. It's been a wild, wild 2 months, and it all ends here in Legends Field. Now, the Bananas versus the Kansas City Monarchs. There's so much that made the Kansas City Monarchs the perfect opponent to take on the Nanners for the first time professionally in Banana Ball. They actually reached out to the Bananas on social media and said, hey, we are really interested in doing this thing, and that's the first step. We're a social media team, aren't we? And it has taken off from there. Now, last night it was a fantastic ball game. The Monarchs ended up coming out on top, but let's show you how it ended up going in the W column for the Kansas City Monarchs. Now, right in the top of the first inning, it was a hit parade for KC. They greeted Kyle Lewis rudely. That's David Thompson hitting in Pete Cosma and Gabby Guerrero. And then an inning later, after the Monarchs won the first 6-0 to take a 1-0 lead in the points category, it was Pete Cosma once again, this time with the lumber, knocking in Darnell Sweeney with the assist of an error from center field from the Bananas. And the Monarchs, 2 innings into the ballgame, well, they were up 2-0, just like that. As you can see, it was a packed crowd, a sellout, 6,000 plus strong here in Legends Field. Alex Ziggy Ziegs, the bat-tricking maestro, trying to get something going in the third for the Nanners, ends up hitting into a fielder's choice, but a wild throw from Kevin Santa ends up allowing Ziegler to take second base. He would be pinch run for by Jacob Teston. And up came Bill Leroy for his first at-bat of the night. He actually got knocked out of the game briefly in the first inning, taking a bouncer off the chin, catching. But he brings home Jacob Teston. And just like that, the Bananas cut the KC lead in half. It is 2-1. Who but the mayor of Bananaland to get it done? And Bill now down to a knee to honor the great Bill Lee, as he should. 75 years strong, Bill has been a fan favorite, very understandably so, throughout the World Tour. And he was dealing last night. Bouncer to Andrew Don, the third baseman, only man on the left side of the infield. Not a double play. If you watch it on replay, you might disagree with Seth Strickland. He's sick of hearing it, though, so please do not bring it up to him. That's Johnny Gomes, former, over 10 years in Major League Baseball, dapping up Bill Lee, the 14-year MLB vet. And look at that, Jacob Teston at the dish this time. After scoring the walk-off run in the third inning, he brings home Breland Almodova, who Jack Sparrows his way onto home plate. I think we will see that one on the interwebs, whether it's TikTok, Instagram, Twitter, it'll be there. And of course, how about a little jump on it celebration? You can't hear the music through the highlight, but I'll play it for you. It's the classic, nah, 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 nah. So now you really understand what was going on there. Now, into the top of the sixth inning. Game still knotted at 2, but Colin Ledbetter walks Daryl Graham. That brings in Alex Lahasky. And the party animals, check that. The Kansas City Monarchs able to take a 3-2 lead. Got party animals on the mind. Dalton Cornett with the game on the line. 3-2 pitch. Pops it up into the crowd. And it is caught by a woman. Of course, in Banana Ball, if you catch a foul ball in the air, it's an out. Eric Burns, the 11-year Major League Baseball vet, head coach of the Bananas, absolutely flabbergasted. And surprisingly, that's not actually how the game ended. Because everybody around that woman, they were all saying, no, no catch, no catch. They did not want to see the game end that way. Vincent Chapman, the home plate umpire, actually said, okay, clearly the fans say there wasn't a catch, so there must not have been a catch. So the Monarchs went out on the field, did a big time celebration, as they deservedly should, and then they had to get called back off the field. The fielders had to come back out. Dalton Cornett got another chance at a 3-2 pitch, and it ended up being another really good one off of the hand of Brett Baker. Backdoor breaking ball caught Dalton Cornett looking. The Monarchs got two celebrations for the price of one as they won the game 3-2. Whoa, and I see Savage Kiwi, OMG, 6'4", 2'8", an 80-1 odds horse just won the Kentucky Derby. Breaking news, how about that? Bruce, it is great to see you in the comments section, my man. Thank you to everybody watching our final broadcast of the Banana Ball World Tour here in 2022. It is an honor to have you on YouTube. It's an honor to have you on the No Filter Network. We are on two networks, simulcast, baby, and really, really excited to bring you the second night of the inaugural Challenger Series between the Bananas and the Kansas City Monarchs. So as you saw there, a tight affair. The Monarchs ended up squeaking out a 3-2 victory, and I will tell you what, the Bananas do not want to hop on a plane early tomorrow morning and head back east with an 0-2 weekend in the first ever Challenger Series. So there will be some serious competition on the field today. There's certainly going to be a lot of shenanigans as well. This game is meant to be fun. It's meant to be entertaining. There is a lot of competitiveness, but if everybody has a good time, then everyone goes home happy, and that's what we're hoping to do. So you got to see Kyle and Dan trying out some Kansas City barbecue in rather unique fashion. Don't know why they never invite me to any of their powwows there. I love barbecue. I actually checked out Joe's this past Wednesday night when Kirk Kessler and I pulled the Penske with all of our equipment here into Kansas City, and it was delicious. But I waxed poetic, and I must stop. There is a lot more to Kansas City than just barbecue. Of course, Kansas City, the Monarchs are not the first team called the Kansas City Monarchs to call this place home. The Negro Leagues were actually incepted here in Kansas City back in 1920, and the legendary Kansas City Monarchs were a mainstay of the Negro Leagues. An original team from 1920 to 1931, was independent for 6 years after that. 37-61, they were back dominating the league. And the entire Bananas staff, as well as some of the great folks from ESPN documenting us on this world tour journey, got to check out the Negro League Museum. And nobody, well, hey, look at the back of that head. That's a good looking shirt there. Nobody more excited, I think, than Bill Lee. I was a kid in a candy shop as well, but Bill actually played with and against a handful of these players that are, enshrined forever in Kansas City in the Negro League Museum. So it was a really, really, really incredible experience. I would throw 20 more reallys on that if it wasn't a good broadcast behavior. It was eye-opening, and you know, I consider myself a very knowledgeable historian of baseball. Baseball is my favorite thing in the entire world. That's why I'm here talking to you today. And as much as I knew about the history of the game, my world has been expanded tenfold by just a couple hours. Thank you so much to Bob Kendrick, the president of the Negro League Museum, and everybody who works there for giving us just an eye-opening and a tremendous, tremendous experience there, because there's a lot of history in the Negro League Museum that is not mainstream, and there's, you know, not all history is told through the right lens. So anyway, I can't recommend everybody getting to check out the Negro League enough. It's a must-see for anybody who enjoys history of this country, enjoys baseball, any of the above. I've got to turn it down to the field because Jake Schwartz, our resident magician, has a little trick for us. Here's Jake.
Who will have to pass two tests to prove he has what it takes to be the next Bananas magician. Jackson, your first test will be to make this glass of water disappear. Jackson, the water goes in the cup gets handed to you. Jackson, hold that out like you're cheersing the crowd, and I'll walk you through how to make it vanish. Jackson, hold it above your head just like this. Now the audience and I will count you down, and once we get to one, you will turn that cup over. If you do it right, that water will vanish. If you do it wrong, we're gonna have one damp banana on our hands. All right, audience, help me count down. Here we go, ready? 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Jackson, turn it over. Can he do it? Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, Jackson has made a glass of water disappear. Now, Jackson, it is time for your second and final test. Jackson, we have a game of banana ball to get to, but we're a little short on baseball. That is where you come in as the banana magician. Take this, Jackson, show it to everyone so they can all see that it's empty. Audience, can we get an ooh? Jackson, hold on to that. I'm gonna give you the lid right here. Watch your fingers, Jackson. Do you have a magic word for us?
Banana.
Banana, that's a good one. Jackson, lift the lid on. Do we have baseballs? Yes! Jackson has successfully made baseballs appear. He has what it takes to be a banana magician. Give it up one more time for the newest banana magician, Jackson. This has been your magic moment of the night. Shark, back to you.
Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for Jake Schwartz.
Oh man, Jake Schwartz, I do not know how the man does it. There is truly magic in that fellow's fingertips. Now, time to dive into the comment section really quick. I promise you there will be a lot of explaining tonight for anybody who has not seen Banana Ball before and they are looking for a little guidance as far as the rules to this young sport. This is only the 21st Banana Ball game played all time, and funny enough, the 14th of our tour. So, you know, things are running very quickly in Bananaland, and we're just grabbing on and trying to have fun along for the ride. So heading into the comment section on YouTube, it is going crazy as it was last night. Grandma Coach Marty Barrington, Steve Kellogg, Brad, Jen Pilcher, California Ave, Leanne DeGrandis, Turtle Splat, who likes chicken, me too, Turtle Splat, Chris Dunn, Carson Kelly. It is so great to have you all filling up that chat. That is one of the really unique things about getting to broadcast for the Bananas is a comment section that is undefeated as far as comment sections in the world of sports. It's what it's all about. I feel like I have, last night there were about 25,000 people who watched live with us. I feel like I have 25,000 color commentators. So it is really cool. I've got to dive out of the booth real quick because Bill LeRoy introducing himself to the crowd.
A four-year banana, a CPL champion, University of North Georgia alumni, myself, Bill LeRoy. Kansas City, how are you feeling tonight? That was pretty good, but I think the crowd last night was a little bit louder, so we're gonna try it again. Kansas City, how are we feeling tonight? Ooh, chill bombs. Oh, goodness gracious. Just wanna say thank you guys so much for traveling far and wide, supporting us, coming out and showing love to the Bananas. We couldn't do what we do without you guys coming out here and watching. So we love you guys. Give yourself a round of applause. To show you guys some love, I'm gonna run around the ball field right here and take pictures with each section. When I come to your section, get loud, throw your hands in the air, big smiles, say go Bananas. All right, let's get wild over here.
So there goes Bill LeRoy. As Shark said, if you wanna see the pictures Bill takes on the field, check out Bill's Instagram. He's verified, no big deal. That's actually how we got Eric Burns in the first place. Sliding into the DMs, you would be amazed how much magic in Bananaland has happened by sliding into direct messages. Just look at the CPL championship last year and talk to the coordinator of baseball ops, Barry Aldridge, about that. He's a big proponent of DMs. Now to dive back into the comments real quickly, because the pregame show is about to go full throttle and we will not have a lot of time to chat. That's me to you. You can still go crazy in the comment section. I hope you do. But things are gonna get wild here. Turtle Splat, I do enjoy chicken nuggets. I think they are quite tasty. Our Girl 661 says the Bananas are definitely winning it tonight. I like the prediction, our girl. Peace out, Pat says, I wish they were kind of like the opposite of the Globetrotters, that they never won. That's pretty funny, actually. I think that's not a bad idea. Maybe a spinoff on the Bananas. It is actual competition, and I'm happy that you do love that. But I thought that was actually a pretty funny suggestion there. Mr. Peace Out, Pat. Andrew Voskinarian, Sebastian Mercado, Makai Stallworth, Fire Productions, big fan of chicken nuggets, happy to hear it. Mr. Baseball's going bananas. Capsman09, a legend on the YouTube comments. Wants a game in Maryland. How about against the Aberdeen Ironbirds, the Delmarva Shorebirds, or the Blue Crabs? A lot of teams to choose from in the DMV area. I think all of those are really good, really good suggestions. And I promise you, I know in looking at the comment section that there's so many people asking where the Bananas will go next. And I don't know when it will be announced, but it'll be a lot more than six cities next year. That's a promise from your friendly neighborhood broadcaster, Pico Scala, right here to you. We will be getting a lot more of the country checked off, and we are so, so, so very fired up for that to be the case. Josiah Rich hit a postseason home run. Whoa now. Today he did, and he's going to be hitting homers on the bananas one day. Josiah Rich, I don't doubt that in the slightest. Good start to your young baseball career. Hopefully we'll have you playing in Grayson Stadium and wherever Bananaland is on any given weekend in the future. RMG saying hello from Tampa, Florida. Thank you to everybody watching. Once again, I have to hop off the old mic here because here is the young professor.
We want to get to know you here, Kansas City. We want to know, where did you come to see us from tonight? So who in here came from Kansas or Missouri? All right, not too far though, not too far. We're trying to find out which fans have traveled the absolute furthest to witness this thing we call Banana Ball. So where are some of y'all from? Oklahoma, we got some Oklahoma. We got some Detroit, Michigan, Detroit Rock City. Do we have any California? We got Iowa in the house, shout out to Iowa. We got some Georgia fans in the house. A little Savannah love. We got anybody from California? Somebody said Hawaii? Hawaii in the house. Give it up for Hawaii making the trip. Fun fact, we got fans representing from 32 different states here tonight. Do you guys smell that? I smell love. Love is in the air, ladies and gentlemen. You feel the love, everybody? We want to show a little love, especially on Mother's Day, to some of the married couples in the house tonight. So if you are married, everybody here in the stadium, if you are a married man and woman and you are here tonight together, stand up out of your chairs. All my married couples, get on up. All right, we got a lot of married. Date night here in Kansas City at Legends Field. All right, so everybody here that's been married for 1 year, just 1 year, 1 year only. Congratulations, it's a long road ahead, but if you both...
I am going to interrupt the young professor real quickly because he's gonna build up a lot. We'll probably get to like 55 years of marriage or so. I had to get in here because I saw that I'm Brad came from Burt Chrysler's podcast, and I had to say Burt was such a cool guy to have in Bananaland. He was actually at the February 26th tryout, and that was his first time actually getting to experience what the Bananas were all about. That was the tryout to see what players were going to be in Bananas uniforms eventually right here on the field in front of you today. So it was really cool meeting Burt, and it's so cool that he has brought us up on the podcast a handful of times now because, you know, Bert's just a great guy. Nobody doesn't like Bert. Come on. So he's a great partner. Kevin Riley, great to see you in the comment section. It was even better to see you in the broadcast booth just a few minutes ago, my friend. Great to be in your neck of the woods, finally. All right, back down to the young professor. Let's see how long we have some 10-year couples here. We're at 40 years.
I see a 40-year couple right here. I see some over here. How about 45? We still got one over here, we got one over here. Can anybody do 50? All right, I got a couple 50s.
Hey Matt, other side, Bananas dugout, I see some 50 years.
50 years over there on the third base side, okay. How about 55? 55. We got a couple?
Over there we got 55, Mr. Matt.
Wait a minute. How long?
Hey, Matt, we got 55 over here, my friend. That's amazing.
We got 55 right under here. We got 55. Do we have 60?
I feel like we're in an auction house.
That's exactly what it is. Where are we at? 55? My 55ers, I'm coming to you. Come on over here. Now, ladies and gentlemen, 55 years is a long time. These are allegedly the longest married couple here in the house with us for the Banana Ball exhibition against the Kansas City Monarchs. So my folks, 55 years, go ahead, stand up. Go ahead, stand up. What's your names, folks? Don and Sue. Don and Sue, congratulations on being married for 55 years, but I'd like to do something with you here. I want you guys to take us back, all the way back to your very first night of marriage. We want to relive that night together. Show us a little love here, will you, in Kansas City? Go ahead, let me see that dance moves. Let me see those dance moves. Yeah. Oh, come on. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Go ahead. Oh, that baby. Give it up for marriage, everybody.
Thank you, young professor, and thank you, Kansas City. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, direct your attention to the Bananas dugout and make some noise for Princess Potassia. Gentlemen, Princess Potassia. Now, ladies and gentlemen, the man in the yellow tux, Jesse Cole.
Kansas City, the show is about to get started. We're going to have some fun here. As you know, when we come out here to different cities, we like to bring our cast and have a lot of fun. You've already met some of the Bananas, the official dad bod cheerleading squad. But we want to get one from Kansas City, one from this area that can join us as an honorary dad bod Banana tonight. So fans, it is up to you. These guys are going to show what they got, and you're going to choose who's going to be a Banana tonight. Are you guys with me? All right. Representing Banana Tris, who do we have here?
John.
John? Let's see what you've got, Shark. Here we go. All right, John. All right, that's an interesting move, John. I don't know what that is. It's a weird tiptoe. Oh, that was a gritty. Okay. It's an interesting gritty. You gotta get the hands up. All right, here we go. All right. Now, representing Manana Bruce, who do we have?
Brandon.
Brandon, you're gonna bring it, all right? What do you got, Brandon? Oh. Representing Ben and Marty, who do we have here?
Brent,
let's see what you got. Okay. Oh, ooh, I like it. Get it down. Oh, shake it, Brent. Shake it, Brent. All right. Looking good. All right. Now, who do we have here?
Charlie,
what do you got? Some stiff competition here. Oh. Charlie!
All right.
And last, representing Captain Matt, the Banana, who we have?
Adrian,
what do you got, my friend? Okay, a little tiptoeing. Oh, it's a tease. No. Adrian.
There it goes.
Okay. All right. This is definitely a close competition. right here in Kansas City. Miles away from Legends Field. And he was in a little show they called Modern Family. Please welcome Wine County's favorite son, Eric Stonestreet. All right, Eric, what do you got, man? Oh, all right. Oh, he's bringing it right now. He needs the music louder, louder. All right, Eric Stonestreet right here. All right, let's see, fans, it's up to you. Who's gonna be an honorary Banana today? All right, let's start right here. Is it John? All right, good effort. What about right here, Brandon? Oh. All right, here, Brent. Oh, yeah. Charlie. Adrian. Or what about Eric Stonestreet right here? We brought in the ringer. And in second place, Brandon joins us. But let's hear it for all our contestants. We're going to have some fun tonight.
Man, that's a tough break for Brandon. He actually put forth one of the better performances from a Bandana hopeful that I've ever seen in my 2+ years of broadcasting Bananas baseball. Bananas banana ball also. Eric Stonestreet comes out. Obviously, the hometown kid's gonna get the crowd going. Now, speaking of get the crowd going, here's Split trying to get some energy into this place. Yeah, he's not happy with what he's seen from the left field stands. Right field side. Oh, boy. Okay, now everybody together. City, Kansas, as the Bananas have taken the field and are now performing their signature weave, seen from our banana panorama, the eye in the sky. The weave crafted by the Bananas director of entertainment, Zach Frangelo, got his inspiration from basketball layup lines and hockey warm-ups, made who came from the Vegas Golden Knights before joining with us folk. And now that the weave is complete, time to fire around some balls. Three baseballs in the air at once. Let's make it four now that Bill's got that one going back around. Constant action, constant entertainment from the minute you step in the building to a Bananas game. And please let us know in the comment section if there is a more exciting warm-up in sports, because I certainly do not think so. And I'm Brad, you are correct. Every seat in this ballpark, if you purchased it from the Savannah Bananas, and not a secondary ticket source, it was $20 and $20 on the dot. We do not do taxes. Well, of course, you can't just not do taxes. We pay for your taxes. And there are no fees, we cover those as well. It's 20 bucks to get in the building. You just gotta make sure you're on the priority list and you're able to get the tickets quickly when they go on sale, because they don't last much longer than a couple hours when we open up games. If you're in Grayson Stadium, our home back in Savannah, Georgia, it's all you can eat. Burgers, hot dogs, fries, soda, Powerade, chips, cookies, yada yada. Popcorn. On the road, we let the home folks run the food and bev, so whatever they've got going on, they've got going on. But it is fans first, entertainment for a reason. Everything we do, the first thing we think of is, do the fans want this? And if they don't, we don't do it. The team took the advertisements out of Grayson Stadium in February of 2020 because they felt like, well, the fans don't want to be advertised to. They're not coming to a game to be advertised to. It's, tell you what, some really good stuff in the infield there. How about Adam Byron, assistant coach of the Savannah Bananas, getting after it with the glove in hand. And it looks like we've got Maceo Harrison, the Bananas dancing first base coach, coming on down the chute. What you got for us, Maceo? Ooh! Three flips for the price of one. Boys getting riled up and ready to rock and roll here. Paula Berman, very happy to hear that you enjoy the weed. A Banana season tickets holder and host family since day one back in 2016 when the club was incepted into the lives of folks in Savannah. It was just a show for Savannah up until last spring. In spring of 2021, the Bananas took the show on the road for the first time, the One City World Tour, after two games of professional banana ball in Grayson Stadium. We packed our bags and headed to Mobile, Alabama, beautiful Hank Aaron Stadium, which unfortunately is no more, and put on two of the more exciting shows we've ever had, and that proved to us that the world was hungry for banana ball. This is now the sixth and final city we're taking it to this spring, and there will be plenty more come next year, maybe even this fall. I don't want to put the carriage out in front of the horse, though. Down to the field, here comes Jesse Cole.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jesse Cole.
All right, fans, now that the players are warmed up, it's time to get you warmed up. So please welcome, to get you warm up, our kid right here. Welcome, Finn. All right, six-year-old Finn. We're gonna get some music, and whatever Finn does, you guys do. We're gonna get stretched out and get it loose. Finn, are you ready?
Yes.
All right, Finn, let's get some music, Shark. Get those hands going like Finn. Here we go. Oh, yes, keep it going, Finn. Oh, pump those fists. Pump those fists. Keep it going. Keep it going, Finn. Oh, yes. Keep it going. Oh, jumping jacks.
Keep going.
strike here. Here you go, Danny. Oh! Oh my goodness!
Whoa!
64 miles an hour! The world's fastest thrown banana! Let's hear it for Daniel! Wow! That is unbelievable.
As are most things that happen in Bananaland, Jesse Cole, 64 miles per hour. We actually had a man figure out how to throw a banana at 90 miles per hour, but he froze it, chopped it up, and put it inside a baseball, so kind of cheating. But you know what? You got to do what you got to do. Back down to the field, Jesse Cole for the banana baby.
It is time for one of the most amazing traditions in Bananaland. Since day one, back on May 28, 2016, we've introduced a very important part of our team. They've represented us through hard times and great times, but it's a very important moment because tonight we're introducing tonight's Banana Baby. Please welcome those hands going. Flint is 4 months old, weighing 16 pounds, and he's sticking his tongue out in utter glee or confusion. But Flint looks very happy. The bananas are feeling the vibes. And fans, let's hear it for tonight's Banana Baby.
Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Challenger Series Game 2 between your Savannah Bananas and the Kansas City Monarchs. Let's meet their starting lineup. The Kansas City Monarchs are managed by Joe Calfapietra. Leading off at second base, number 17, Darnell Sweeney. Extra hitter number 4, Pete Kosma. Left fielder number 15, Gabby Guerrero. Designated hitter number 12, Matt Adams. Right fielder number 10, Yan Hernandez. First baseman number 16, Casey Gillespie. Third baseman number 8, David Thompson. The catcher number 32, J.C. Escara. Center fielder number 26, Willie Abreu. And the shortstop number 1, Kevin Santa. On the mound for the Monarchs, number 24, Brandon Koch.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's time to meet our first batter of the evening. Please welcome 4-year-old Bryson, who's going to be stepping in the batter's box. He's going to get his first at bat against the Kansas City Monarchs. Now, Bryson, don't crowd the plate, buddy. Here we go. Let's back you up. Vincent Chapman, let them know how do we do things here. All right, let's see what you got, buddy. He's ready for the pitch. Wait a minute, are you throwing strikes to the kid? Hold on, all right. Come on, Bryson, we believe in you. We feel this one. Oh, wait, come on, you got to pitch to the kid. Wait a minute. There we go. There we go, there we go. This is more like it, here we go. All right, Bryson, let her rip, swing it there, hit that ball. Now go, go, Bryson, go.
Wow, the bat travels farther than the ball, but Bryson is off to the races anyhow with a very steady trot down the first baseline. The ball being tracked down, and it's going to be played by Casey Gillespie. He's firing it in as Bryson very methodically makes his way towards second. Play not made there. Throw over the head of Darnell Sweeney. Gabby Guerrero kicking the ball around in left field. Bryson's digging towards third. He's got at least three bases on his mind. He dare not go four, though. He dare not go for home. Oh, Bryson, you madman. Pete Cosma with a toss in. Oh, my goodness. Over the head of J.C. Ascara. Touching home plate. It's a home run. Bryson has done the improbable, and some would say the impossible. Oh, Bryson, what an incredible performance, young man. Very exciting trip around the bags. Once again, the young professor.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is time to learn the rules of banana ball. And I am your banana announcer, the young professor. The following game of banana ball is scheduled for 9 innings or a 2-hour time limit. In banana ball, there is no bunting. There are no walks. Batters may not step outside of the batter's box. And there are absolutely no mound visits. If any of you fans catch a foul ball here tonight, that will count as an out. Batters can steal first base. Whichever team scores more runs inside of an inning scores 1 point for that inning, so every inning counts. The team with the most points will win the game or the first of five. If we are tied at the end of our 2-hour time limit, it will force a showdown tiebreaker, pitting one hitter versus one pitcher and one fielder. And now that you know the rules, it is time for the traditional banana ball weigh-in, ladies and gentlemen. So let's introduce from the Kansas City Monarchs, making his way, strutting and cutting through the lineup. Ladies and gentlemen, they call him Big City. It's Matt Adams. He's got the big gold with him. All right, Big City's on the scale. Vincent Chapman, what's the official call here? That's 260 pounds for the Kansas City Monarchs. And representing your Savannah Bananas, ladies and gentlemen, making his way onto the scale, number 23, Colin Ledbetter. He weighs in this evening at 230 pounds of potassium power. Now face off, here's Vincent Chapman with the rule. 3, 2, 1, go!
Bananas magician, the Mananas, aka the Dad Bod cheerleading squad, split the strongest banana in the entire world. Everybody getting after it. All over Legends Field here. Quite a way to kick off the festivities this evening. The Bananas pep band blaring away, the cast and crew firing gold beads at anyone and everyone in the crowd, and here's Jesse Cole.
Let's hear it for your Banana pep band! Now it's time for a tradition here, for a little Can't Stop the Peeling. So let me see your hands, Banana Nation. Oh, they're bringing it tonight, Shark.
Absolutely they are.
All right, please welcome from the cast, our breakdancing first base coach, please welcome Maceo. And she'll be singing and having fun all night, the only princess in baseball, Princess Potassia. And he'll be having fun with you all night, the Bananas magician, Jake. And you'll see them getting you pumped up with energy. The only dad bar cheerleading squad in the land, the Mariners! And rocking it all night on the Bananas dugout, please welcome the King of Potassium, Split! Keep those hands going, Banana Nation. We're gonna make tonight unforgettable. Let me see you out there in the burn. Oh, you guys look good. And your Bananas cast, welcome to Bananaland.
Ladies, gentlemen, boys and girls, and potassium enthusiasts from around the world, this is the moment you have all been waiting for. We, over 6,000 screaming banana maniacs here live, and the millions watching at home, descend upon Legends Field to see this. This is a game played by the world's most entertaining players. This is a non-stop thrill ride, the likes of which has never been seen. This is the showcase of the immortals, played by beings who are half man and half God. This is not baseball. This is not your granddad's pastime. And Toto, we are not in Kansas anymore. It is time for you, the 6,000 fans, to get up on your feet and give me your voices. Because this is the greatest show in sports. This is Banana Ball!
Your Savannah Bananas are managed by Eric Burns. Assisted by Michael Bobby Barrels Kowalski. And Adam Viro Virens. Leading off at catcher, number one, Bill LeRoy. Batting second in right field, number five, Tanner Thomas. DH, first base, number 19, Dan Oberst. Third baseman, number 15, Andrew Todd. Shortstop number three, Dalton Cornett. In left field, number 20, Breland Almodova. Number seven, Chris Vasquez. Second baseman, number 13, Dalton Molden. And center fielder, number eight, Jacob Tested.
And on the mound tonight for your Savannah Bananas, from the magic city of Miami, Florida. Ladies and gentlemen, he is a wheelin' dealin', kiss-stealin', son of a gun, number 23, Christian Dearman!
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing and remove your caps. Here tonight to honor America with the playing of our national anthem, please welcome the Bananas Pep Band. Savannah Bananas! All right, Kansas City, let's get loud!
Wow, what a scene here at Legends Field. Kansas City, Kansas. As we are just moments away from game two of the first ever Challenger Series. The Monarchs are the first professional baseball team that has ever played the Bananas in their sport of banana ball. The Nanners will be the home team, even though they are in foreign ground here. Christian Dierman's first warm-up pitch off the top of the net. This is also the 14th and final game of the 2022 Banana Ball World Tour. 12 games between the Bananas and Party Animals. These last two between the Nanners and the Monarchs. And then we will prepare for the Coastal Plain League Collegiate Summer Baseball that will kick off May 24th in Grayson Stadium. We will be broadcasting that live for free on YouTube, just like all these games have been, except for the 7th and 8th that were on ESPN Plus back in Savannah. And it'll be a really special thing. It's going to be these pro bananas. Well, I'm interrupted by Jesse Cole.
It's time for the words we've all been waiting for. On three, we're all going to yell play ball. One, two.
Two magic words, play ball, preceded by three magic words, start the clock. A reminder in case you missed the young professor's explanation of the rules of banana ball. This is a 2-hour game. It's a rolling clock. It does not stop for anything. At the end of the 2-hour time limit, we'll be done. We have to, a little delay of game as three Monarchs pitchers, as well as a couple coaches, have to make their way in from the bullpen. Pitching coach Mike Henneman holding up the rear, and Christian Dierman just fooling around on the mound. Well, he waits for the coaches to depart right field. Zach Frangelo is incredibly shook by what's going on, and we're going to start the game anyway. Darnell Sweeney, the second baseman, in the box. Couple pitches outside. He was 2-for-2 with a double, a single, a stolen base, and two runs scored last night. He faces the three-year banana collegiately, Christian Dearman, who has began his professional career as the number two starter behind Kyle Lewis on the tour. 2-2 count on the former Philadelphia Phillies and Toronto Blue Jays product. Swing and a miss. Dearman gets Sweeney with the breaking ball. First time Darnell has been retired so far in the Challenger Series. And a heck of a start for the Florida native on the bump. Now Pete Cosma will try his luck. The man out of Broken Arrow, Oklahoma, an eight-year Major League Baseball veteran, most recently with the Oakland Athletics just this past summer. The Tigers, Yankees, Rangers, and most notably, the Cardinals before that. And before I could finish talking about his rather illustrious Major League Baseball career, he goes down swinging. Two men up, two men struck out by Christian Dearman. He is so far meeting a much different fate than Kyle Lewis last night. The Monarchs jumped on Kyle for six runs in the top of the first. Wow! Hidden dragon, crouching tiger, Christian Dearman. Going with the karate kick, now dancing all over the mound. Gabby Guerrero takes that one for a strike. Count 1-1 on the left fielder for the Monarchs. Fouled back, count 1-2. Gabby was 1-for-2 last night, an RBI single and a run scored. He also fouled out to a fan. Remember, if fans catch a foul ball in the air, it's an out. And strike three, Christian Dearman. Three up, three men with K's in the scorebook. Oh my goodness gracious, how about that? The Monarchs, who came out gangbusters yesterday, have nothing for Dearman, and you want to talk about a two-seam fastball. That puppy had some comeback. Vincent Chapman with a little something special on the strikeout call there. And the Bananas, now with a chance to have a very different start tonight, two of the Challenger Series here against the Kansas City Monarchs. And by the way, for all of the talk about balks in the comment section on YouTube, there are no balks in banana ball if nobody is on base. It's kind of the 10th unwritten rule that allows us to do all of our TikTok dances that have kind of taken our already powerful TikTok to whole new heights over the past 2 months. We now have 2.4 million followers on the talk. That's nearly 2 million more followers than any Major League Baseball team. Few teams around the 600,000 mark. And now the Bananas in the driver's seat. The way banana ball works, as the young professor said in the pregame, if you win an inning, you get a point. So with the Monarchs scoring six runs yesterday, there really was not a good chance for the Bananas to do anything in the first inning. But now, with no runs across, all the Bananas need to do is score one time, and they'll take a 1-0 lead. Here comes Eric Burns around the field, the young professor introducing him.
In all of sports, give it up for Eric Burns!
Leading off for your Bananas fans, I need you to get those hands together. Catcher! Numero uno, Bill Leroy.
The Prince of Bananaland himself, four-year collegiate banana, the five-year man from the University of North Georgia, the Nighthawk, will lead it off, the catcher for the Nanners. Last night, 1-for-2 with a run batted in, a walk-off at net. Hit a hop shot down the third base line to bring in Jacob Teston to win the third inning. Brandon Coach on the mound, and first pitch swinging. Bill sends that one out of the park. No danger for a fan to catch that one. coach the pride of Plano, Texas, out of Dallas Baptist University out there in the WAC. And spent some time in the Rays and Twins organizations, that one across the diamond. Throw from David Thompson in time, so Bill would be retired. And looks like a yellow carpet is being unveiled out of the Bananas dugout.
Right fielder number 5, Tanner Thomas.
Wow. Some flashing lights, a little paparazzi show for the Bananas right fielder. Oh, he just kissed Christopher Vasquez right on the hand.
Who are you wearing?
Dolce Banana.
Wow. Well, Dolce Banana from Tanner Thomas. A break in the character there once or twice. You see a smile creeping onto the face. Well, the man out of Tallahassee Community College for a couple years, 3 years at Virginia Tech after that. He was a party animal for the first 12 games of the World Tour. Takes that one for ball one. Last night, 1-for-3 with a double off the right field wall.
Let's do that louder this time, y'all.
And the pitch there from the fourth rounder back in 2015, drafted by the Rays, up and out. Thomas ahead 2-0. Now that one shot towards the fans. It'll be knocked down by the netting. Funny enough, Brandon Coach actually started his professional career playing for the Hudson Valley Renegades, just about 45 minutes away from my home. Saugerties, New York. The minor league club I've frequented far more than any other. That one off the hands, but Tanner Thomas got enough on it, ducks down into center field for a base knock. Tanner treating the Dolce
and
Banana
well.
And now,
ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the plate from right center field, he is a World Series champion with the Boston Red Sox and a World Series champion with your Kansas City Royals. Give it up for Johnny Gomes!
So Johnny Gomes taking the long route to home plate. American flag in hand. The DH for the Nanners. And a man beloved in this city. Passes the flag off to Eric Burns. 13-year major league man hands it off to the 11-year major league vet. And now Johnny will have his fourth career at bat as a Savannah Banana, 0-for-3 last night. That one gets the bottom of the zone. Johnny hasn't slapped cleats on since the end of his playing career around 2016. 2015 was his last year at Major League Baseball when he won the World Series with the hometown folks here, the Kansas City Royals. Won the World Series with the Boston Red Sox 2 years prior. A beloved major leaguer everywhere he's gone. And able to foul off the 86 mile per hour offering there from Coach. Just like Coach on the mound, Johnny Gomes came up in the Tampa Bay Rays organization, although it was the Devil Rays when he started out. Fastball up at 93 miles per hour. Count 1 and 2 on Johnny. 2003 to 2007, he was a Devil Ray. 2008 was the name change. He was a Ray for one more year before shipping off to Cincinnati. Played two more seasons for the Reds. That breaking ball misses the top of the zone. Brandon Coach not so sure of it. I'm not so sure of it either. Vincent Chapman punched Johnny Gomes out looking on a 3-2 pitch to lead off the bottom of the seventh inning last night when the Monarchs were winning the game 3-2. maybe a makeup call there once again. Vincent Chapman thinks it's up. So does Johnny Gomes. Coach respectfully disagrees. See if Tanner Thomas is off on the pitch. 3-2. Coming with one down. Thomas takes off, and it's a grounder softly to third. Across the diamond. Once again, David Thompson able to make the play. Tanner Thomas holds up at second base, and now Danny Oberst. Walk to home plate with the assist of the Bananas Pep Band. Danny, a three-year collegiate banana, a CPL champion last summer alongside Bill Leroy, Christian Dierman, Matt Malatesta, and Kyle Lewix, all playing professionally on this team as well. All five of them won the Breakfast Bowl just a few weeks after the championship, and now have reunited to play professionally for the Nanners. Tanner Thomas has third base stolen easily, but Danny had to swing the lumber, fouls it off. I mean, he didn't really have to swing the lumber. It was a 1-0 pitch, but the Bananas first baseman liked what he saw. Nobody holding on Thomas at second. Now Darnell Sweeney, the second baseman, will give him a little bit of attention. Coach comes home. That one shot towards center field. It's gonna be in the gap. Tanner Thomas is gonna score easily. Danny Oberst walks off the bottom of the first inning, and the Bananas take a 1-0 lead. Hitting there from Danny Oberst as you see him drive it to the left center field gap. Not a chance in the world for Willie Abreu in center or Gabby Guerrero in left. And now here comes Jesse Cole. As you can see, Joe Calfapicha, the head coach of the Monarchs, had some choice words for Vincent Chapman. Just like Brandon Coach, I don't think he thought those two breaking balls to Johnny Gomes were high. That's a discussion for another day. Here's Jesse Cole.
So this promotion is called Pie My Dad. And we have four-year-old Cooper here. Let's hear it for Cooper. And we have his dad. And Cooper, this is a very simple game. We're gonna ask you if you want some Bananas merchandise or if you wanna pie your dad in the face. So Cooper, very simple. Do you want a Bananas baseball or do you wanna pie your dad?
Pie my dad.
He's gonna pie his dad. There we go, Cooper, get a good one. Oh!
Yeah.
All right, Cooper, now, do you want a signed bat from all the Bananas, or do you want to pie your dad?
Pie my dad.
He's going to pie his dad again. Here you go, Cooper. Make it good. Oh! All right, the last one, Cooper. I know you're going to want this. A Bananas t-shirt, or do you want to pie your dad?
Pie my dad.
Oh! Very excited for this one. Here we go. Oh! Cooper, for being such a good sport, you get the ball, you get the bat, and you get a t-shirt. Let's hear it for Cooper and his dad. Great job, buddy.
Well, Cooper with the right answer three times in a row and rewarded for his work.
Number 12, the DH, Matt Adams.
that. Big City Matt Adams leading off the top of the second inning for the Monarchs, who find themselves in a 1-0 hole just one inning into this ball game. That one skied into shallow left. Andrew Don, the third baseman, makes the call. He'll make the catch. And the DH for the Monarchs, 0-2 last night, strikeout and a pop up. With no luck here. 10-year MLB vet, was playing with the Colorado Rockies last summer. World Series champion in 2019 with the Washington Nationals. Has played with the Braves and Cardinals before that. Most notably is his time with the Cardinals. Now the count 0-2 on Yan Hernandez. Checks his swing, and it's a foul ball. And Bill is telling Vincent Chapman that it's a foul ball. Oh my goodness. The right fielder for the Monarchs. 1-2 last night, single and a run scored. That one misses low and away, count now 1-2. Dearman works incredibly fast, and he has 4 strikeouts through 5 batters. Now, a football thrown out to Bill Leroy. Here comes Christian Dearman. Oh, I do not think that's a field goal. Looked wide left from up here. As I mentioned, Dearman works at a furious pace. He had a 2-minute and 5-second top of the first inning in which he struck out the side, which is the quickest strikeout at the side in banana ball history by far. And the 5th fastest inning ever recorded in general. Now Casey Gillespie, first baseman, a 3-year Kansas City Monarch, is quickly in an 0-2 hole after fouling a couple pitches off, none of them playable by the fans. Dearman home and fires that one up and out. Count 2-2. Gillespie 0-2 last night, a fly out and a K. 2-2 pitch, knocked down by Danny Oberst. It's a race to first. He fires to Dearman and not in time. A little bit of a discombobulated play. I think Dearman actually thought it was going to get through the hole. Seemed like he left the mound a smidge delayed. As you can see, watched it for a second, had a little hezzy hay, and then Dan Oberst went full Jose Iglesias, parallel to the ground, and fired high. So Gillespie will be credited with a single. That ball was rocketed. Dan really did all he could with it. Now David Thompson, the third baseman, couple of putouts in the first, fires it to his counterpart, Andrew Don with a heck of a play, and a scoop on the other end by Dan Oberst. A 3-minute and 16-second inning with Christian Dearman. And the Bananas with another chance for a 1-0 win of an inning. Here's Jesse Cole.
High third base and left field. Let's hear it over here. And the way this works is we're going to play 3 songs. When the song finishes, we finish that song there. But we're going to make it a little competition. Matt, who you got over there?
Well, the professor is over here, Jesse, with the best in class of Kansas City on the first base side.
All right, I hear you. But we got everyone from the Bananas dugout all the way to the wall. We call this the winning section. All right, first song, Shark.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah, first point goes to Matt. Nice job, Matt.
Yes, let's go.
Second song.
Oh, we got this one.
Smokes. Jesse, you just tied it up. It's tied at 1.
All right, let's get this last going.
Last song.
Oh, here we go. We got this. Here we go.
Well, since everybody loves a great comeback story, Jesse, you win! Nice job!
Jesse Cole victorious for the 12th time in 14 games on the World Tour.
Allow me to introduce to you the world's only second base coach. Make some noise and give it up for Mr. Michael Bobby Barrels Kowalski!
Bobby Barrels with a head first dive into second.
Number 15.
The little
Andrew
guy does not
Tom.
Follow suit. Burnsy will run him off the field. Now Andrew Don. And his second career game as a Savannah Banana was a party animal last spring and did it again this year. That one might have some English on it, but it's gonna stay foul. Andrew not busted out of the box. Knew where that ball was headed. Third baseman for the Bananas. 2 for 2 last night, coming off the bench. And by the way, new man on the mound, Jacob Lindgren. 12th round draft pick of the Chicago Cubs back in the day. Seven games pitched for the New York Yankees, and he's able to get Donnie swinging on the breaking ball.
Number 3, Dalton D.C. Cornett.
Dalton Cornett will try his luck, lefty on lefty.
Hey, remember the time I said sing along if you knew this song?
The party animal for the first 12 games of the World Tour, just like Donnie before him in his first game as a Banana, and dots that one just inside the line down the left field line and sliding into second base with a double. Mr. Cornett, the potential walk-off run for the inning. First hit of the Challenger Series after going 0-for-3 last night. Heck of a piece of hitting. Threw the bat head out on it, and the pride of Pippa Passes, Kentucky, is in scoring position. Breland Almodova chugs one of his own company's Monoliving smoothies and steps into the plate. And while Breland steps into the plate, stepping up to the microphone is yesterday's starting pitcher for the Savannah Bananas, Kyle Lewix.
testing. 1, 2, 3. Hello, Vico.
Yeah, coming through loud and clear. It is great to have you. Thank you for coming up to the booth, my friend.
It is even better to be with you.
You flatter me. The left fielder for the Nanners. 1-for-1 with a two-base sprint and a run scored last night. A very memorable one at that. What did you think of his, I think we're calling it a Jack Sparrow.
It's got to be the patented Jack Sparrow run.
Yeah.
Definitely took me by surprise. I thought we were only doing, oh.
Grounder to the left side. Cornett scampers back to second, and Breland will be thrown out by Kevin Santa.
My understanding on it was that we were only doing it when we were going to score.
Yes.
And not running necessarily to first or second base,
right, right.
Which was a different take on it. He was probably only going to get 2 on a walk anyways there. So I think it worked out and gave the fans a good show at the same time.
Yeah, I couldn't agree more. You know, I think he probably would have only had 3rd on the walk, and a run wouldn't have scored with 2 outs there anyhow.
Definitely. Now, we got the second base coach out there. I don't know if you highlighted it, Coach Mike Kowalski out there, Bobby Barrels.
Yeah, I'm a big fan of Bobby Barrels myself. The only second base coach in the game. Christopher Vasquez in the box, the extra hitter for the Bananas, fouled out to a fan last night in his only plate appearance. Can't catch up to the heater, 88 miles per hour. Count even at 2-2. The inning-winning run leading off second base in the form of Dalton Cornett. Jacob Lindgren trying to make it a 0-0 inning, and he's able to get it by Vazzy. couple Ks and a very banana ball like celebration there from Lindgren.
I think I've been telling everybody all weekend, and I made sure to tell a lot of the guys that I saw for the Monarchs before the game, pregame today, just how awesome they did with it. You know, this being their first banana ball game yesterday, their second one today, just how involved they got with it.
Couldn't agree more, and I'd love to hear more about it, but we got to turn it down to the field. Maceo and the boys.
Ladies and gentlemen, your Bananas players.
Well, just an unbelievable job done by the boys there. Matt Wolf, Matt Malatesta, Lucas Kelly, and Colin Ledbetter. And we welcome you into the booth. Kyle, how good does it feel to finally have a camera that can fit my height and your height? I don't know how we did it.
It's definitely not the easiest task in the world, I'll say, but I don't know how you managed to do it. But it's beautiful. Looks beautiful. I think we look great. I think you really look great. The fans of Kansas City looks great. I think everybody looks great. It's incredible. It's a great night to be in your presence and everybody else's.
I couldn't have ever said it any better myself. Now, your dear friend Christian Dearman.
Oh.
Yeah, that was pretty snazzy. Inside to J.C. Escara, the catcher. It's going to be 8-9-10. In the Monarchs' order here. Dearman mowing him down. What have you seen out of your good buddy, three-year teammate on the Bananas?
It's been really good stuff. You know, I think we picked up on a couple tendencies.
Tanner Thomas is not paying attention. He was talking to fans in right field. It should have been a single. It's a good throw, though, and he's safe. Ascara narrowly avoids the tag of Cornette.
Yeah, I've never seen that one in all my years of banana ball. I've never seen anything like. I've actually never seen something like that happen ever in any sporting event.
Well, you know what it reminded me of in 2020 when we first debuted in Practical Bananas and Logan Foster had
his fighting the bees.
He was fighting the bees. He was pretending to urinate on the outfield
wall. Yes, of course.
He was staring right at the outfield wall, but the ball was never hitting his direction. Luckily.
Yes, and whoever was coming up with all those jokes is. A mighty funny guy, obviously.
I can only imagine.
It was me, in case you guys were wondering at home. I was the one coming up with those. The 3-2-2.
Yes, but it seems like everybody's involved.
It's the 3-2-2-9.
The entire team 3-2-2-ing and wobbling to their heart's content. Wow. And the pitch bounced towards first.
Oh, get over, Dearman.
Dan's going to race.
Yeah.
Willie Abreu to the bag.
There we go.
Able to beat the Monarch center fielder there.
Yeah, that was awesome. So what we were talking about before, Dearman's had good stuff. I think we picked up on a lot of tendencies from my outing, especially my first inning. Yesterday we figured out, you know, what the guys were hunting, good ways to kind of attack some of the guys. I mean, they got some really, really good hitters.
So you were the bait.
Yeah, pretty much, which I don't mind being. I think it's kind of fun being the test dummy, I guess, for lack of better words. But I think the one thing that he's done really well is work very, very quickly.
Yes. That one fly deep to right. Should get the run in. Tanner's got a good arm. Ascara off from third. The throw, not in time. Sack fly for Kevin Santa, the shortstop. And the Party Animals with their first run of the game. Remember, it's banana ball. So in yellow, that is points. The Bananas won the first inning, so they have 1 point. The Monarchs now will get one run in white on the left side of the scoreboard. And we'll see if they're able to hold off the Bananas in the bottom half. We'll see if Dearman can limit the damage to this. Nice backdoor breaking ball for Darnell Sweeney, who he struck out on three pitches to start off the game. That one skied in the infield. Andrew Don roaming into foul territory. The third baseman for the Nanners will make the catch. And that'll do it for the side. The Monarchs get a run across on one hit in the sacrifice fly. Here's Jesse Cole.
This might be the most energetic crowd we've ever seen, KC. We love you guys. You're amazing tonight. So we've seen that you can sing a little bit, but we like to play lots of noises, lots of sounds throughout the games. So we're going to try a new one tonight. This is called Human Sound Effects. So we're going to have a contest. We're going to have everyone on this side of the field versus this side. And I'm going to say a sound effect, and you guys have to act it out as loud as you can. And we're going to pick a winner. In the middle, just do a sound effect. All right. Here we go. The first one. A big belly laugh. Let me hear you. Okay, okay. I like it. I'm going this section right here. That was loud. Next one. A baby crying. Baby crying.
I've tapped plenty of butt, and my butt has been tapped many a time as well. Speaking from experience, it's actually the best place to be tapped.
Yeah, it's a big muscle.
It's a lot of meat there.
Yeah.
A lot of meat there. Some more than others.
Correct. Luckily, I am blessed in that department. So now, Dalton Malden leading off first. Jacob Teston, the center fielder and 10 hitter, will swing.
Quite a delivery this guy has.
Oh my goodness.
Unorthodox to say the least.
Yeah, I've heard Dan Ober said he plays JUCO ball with him. Says he has two different arm slots. He throws over the top and side.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah, this is actually true. This is fact.
Oh, coming back at us.
That one fouled straight back. CJ Carter, the new man on the mound, started his collegiate career with Dan Obers for a year at Indian River Community College. Boy. Bill knows how to play the crowd when he gets a ball. Uh-oh, that could be caught right there. Oh, it drops down harmlessly. So, Eric, let me just get your thoughts so far on what you've seen 2.5 innings into this ball game.
Well, you asked me to come on and be on the broadcast, and I said, well, I need to take a little of the game in first. I've seen the TikTok videos. I've seen the Instagram. Familiarize myself a little bit, but it is a whole different shall I say, ball game in person. Very, very, very entertaining. And exactly what the sport needs, like the circus atmosphere, the great competitiveness, the athleticism, the bananas bring. I mean, no joke. That arm in right field.
Yeah, Tanner Thomas, who will now be on deck. We've got a little sprint going on here. So all seven fielders have to touch the ball before it's live. A little,
goodness. He scored.
Dalvin Mauldin, head first into home plate. The inning knotted at one run apiece. And give the RBI to Jacob Teston on second base with the two base sprint. Our first of the evening. Now, which do you like better now that you've seen it once? Do you prefer a walk or do you prefer a sprint, Aaron?
Oh, I think a sprint is pretty darn good.
I'm going to be honest with you, if I could chime in for a little bit.
Yes.
I hate the sprint.
Yeah, I would imagine so.
From my perspective.
Yeah.
Anytime I'm out there, I hate it. But yeah, I think, just like you said, I think it's great for the game.
Very entertaining. I mean, from a show perspective, meaning, you know, which is what this is, the world literally is the banana's oyster. This show can become whatever you all want it to be, and I see big things for it.
Well, it's good to hear that from you, and that is what it is. You know, everyone likes to compare this thing to the Harlem Globetrotters of baseball. I say the big difference is between the diamond, between the lines, the guys are competing.
There's definitely a baseball game going on here.
Correct. And great speed on second for the Nanners. Bill shanks that one foul.
The Nanners.
You know, there's only so many ways you can say banana. You got to mix it up.
Yeah. Right? Yeah, I just leaned over to my fiance before I came in here. And I said, you know what sounds good? Banana pudding.
Doesn't it?
Oh, my gosh. With Nilla wafers? You need. Oh.
Another one off
he
the
He takes
touch.
Another one in the butt.
He's just nailing people.
The
Bill
Keysters.
Is also very blessed in that department. I think he's going to be
Man.
All right.
He is.
Another one. What kind of speed's he throwing there?
That was 88.
Yeah. There it is. I see it now.
No, that's it's actually above, right next to where the cage is. You see the two black screens?
It'll
pop up there.
And while we're chatting about pitch speed, Tanner Thomas doing a little lip sync rather, coming up to home plate. See that one on TikTok within the next 72, maybe 96 hours.
Will we get another tush shot here?
I've never seen two tush shots in one inning, personally.
Let alone three.
Yeah, this would be three. This would be a new Nanners record.
The trifecta.
That might be a world record.
Yeah.
This would be a... There we are.
It's only natural we get the ESPN camera up here as well.
Yeah.
So Tanner singled and scored the walk-off run back in the first inning. Reason why the Nanners lead this game 1-0.
Uh-oh, here it comes.
What's coming?
We're 3-0, looking for a sprint here if that guy from second scores
in
the inning.
So ball four, the inning's over. There's no chance.
I'm learning these rules.
Right, that you can get it all the way
here
around.
Okay, here it is.
Yeah, CJ doesn't have the zone.
Right, so now, so this is a sprint.
Exactly.
So this is going to be a run.
Here comes a celebration.
Nailed it.
Here comes
all right.
Celebration.
Celebration. This is unique.
Oh, I like a good running man myself.
Here unbelievable.
Here comes.
Yeah, that's some good running man down there.
Look at little Biscuit Burns down there.
Biscuit Burns. Good form on the running man. Oh, my goodness.
How long have you been with the team?
This will be my... My fifth year with them. I played 4 years with the guy behind the plate that's catching for us. We played for 4 years for the summer team. We played college ball at the University of North Georgia up above Atlanta.
And he's got an arm.
Bill?
That catcher.
Yeah, he's not too shabby back there. I thought I took him out last night. I actually threw a breaking ball in the dirt.
Oh, really?
Hit him
right
in the esophagus.
The chin.
And he was not on the same planet as me for a little bit.
while. I mean, I got to say, from a performance standpoint, this wouldn't be what it is without the athleticism on the field as well. It would be more of a joke. Obviously, we're having fun here. But there's real athletes out here playing ball, which takes it to the next level. Really cool.
And it definitely takes a special person. Like, a lot of these people, it's kind of a painstaking process to like find the right guy that can both entertain and play baseball at a high level. So it's not the easiest thing to do in the world. But you get better after every time, after every game, you get better, more comfortable.
And what a great opportunity for great athletes, right? That not everybody makes it to the majors, not everybody makes it, but to continue your career and entertaining people and making people have a good time, which is, you know, what we all want to do, I guess, in the entertainment business.
Yeah, I couldn't have said it any better myself. And you mentioned it must be fun to be a part of this because the ceiling is the roof, as Michael Jordan said.
Yeah.
You know, the world is our landscape, and we're just painting it. And from experience, being on the inside of the front office, and now Kyle is in the front office as well with us after his 4 years as a college banana.
Hello.
It's nuts. I mean, it's brainstorms every day. You're throwing anything and everything around. Nothing is a bad idea.
Well, I think I created a role for somebody I met down there. I said you guys need a huckster in the stands that only sells bananas.
Yeah.
Banana! And you throw bananas at people.
Yeah, maybe they can juggle.
Right,
a little stuff to it.
You need a clown for sure. I see you got a guy in jeans. You know, I have a clowning background, right?
Yes.
I wanted to be a clown in the circus. You need to hire a former Ringling Brothers clown out here and get them going, like Cirque du Soleil, like the actual circus. It is what we have going on here, guys.
Yeah. Definitely.
It is what we have going on here with great with great sport behind it.
We're also thinking our president last night also had a great idea. Pika, I don't know if you heard about this
one. Oh, I heard.
We're talking about having a roaming umpire in the stands.
Ooh.
To keep track of foul balls. Because if a foul ball is caught, obviously that batter is out.
Right.
So we need somebody, an official, out in the stands to make sure that it's either caught or not caught, because it's hard to see from the field. And now the back and forth conversation is, what does that person wear? What does it look like? Because it's probably not a normal umpire.
Yeah, I think there's so much you guys and gals can do with this. I can't wait to see where it goes. I know the boys, we brought 10-year-old boys, and they were very excited to come and see this. But this is not just for kids. This is for everyone, for sure. Oh, the banana mascot is in the Monarchs dugout.
Look at that.
What do we have going on here? Monarchs are taking a selfie.
He might have gotten kidnapped.
Okay. All right.
It looks friendly. We got to focus on home plate because Vincent Chapman's taking center stage.
What's going on here?
Oh, this is my favorite one yet.
He's doing the LaQuifa.
Yeah, he's doing the
LaQuifa. Oh, no.
Wait for this.
Oh, my God.
His inner drag queen coming
out. What in the world?
Yes.
Oh.
Here comes
that is
part.
A split like I've
Here's
never
the finishing
seen.
Move.
Come on, Vincent.
Here it comes.
Go, give it to
him. Oh, that's a meniscus. Oh, what's he doing to that field?
He's not
sir.
Allowed. We're from Savannah. We don't realize that's not allowed this side of the Mississippi.
Yeah. Sir, this is a Christian field.
Right after you said it's family friendly.
Yeah. Oh,
tough timing for us.
Huh? Umpire, that's good.
he actually had a dance that got so dirty back in Daytona earlier on our.
Well, Daytona, I mean, anything goes to Daytona.
Yeah, I don't know.
It
even what he did might have not been okay. Anywhere.
All right. I think I need to YouTube that.
It's actually, it lives on our Twitter, but we had to take it down from Facebook because a different audience.
It's
a whole different ballgame. I'll tell you what, we were hearing very different things on Facebook than we were hearing on Twitter.
Okay. And we're singing happy birthday to somebody.
To the whole crowd.
Oh. Just in case we don't see him until
they're anybody.
All right. Makes sense. I mean, it's.
Cover all your tracks.
It's incredible. I mean, there's always something going on. It's very entertaining.
Emmanuel Rosario, the new pitcher on the mound, replacing Christian Dearman, who went 3 innings of 1-run ball, 5 strikeouts. And Pete Cosma, the 8-year Major League Baseball veteran in the box, a man of your own St. Louis Cardinals.
Not my own. Don't put me there.
Whoa.
I'm a Roy. My own St. Louis Cardinals.
Yeah, why would
How
I say
dare
that?
You, sir?
Yeah, that's actually a disgrace on my part.
I'll let it go.
You know, I figure it's like 4 hours down the street.
No, very long, far away place.
Yeah, we've got a team in this town.
Yeah.
Pete Cosma of the St. Louis Cardinals.
What do you think of Kansas City? Did you guys have fun?
Oh, my goodness gracious. It's been really good. We got to pull in I got to pull in Wednesday night, a little early, because I was a part of the Penske truck driving 16 hours here. And got a little Joe's Barbecue.
Nice, good.
Phenomenal. Negro League Museum earlier today.
Yep.
That was borderline life-changing.
Who gave you the tour?
Bob Kendrick.
Oh, the best.
The one and the only. I feel like that's the only person that can give you a tour if you go there.
Yeah, he is a legend and a true American treasure. Oh, gosh.
Yeah, speaking of American treasures.
The umpire is down on the ground again.
An emphatic punch out. Pete Cosma goes down via the strikeout for the second time tonight.
Left fielder number 15, Gabby Carrero.
So where do you guys go from here?
This is it. This is it.
This is the final stop.
Yeah.
Oh, really?
This is game tour. 14 of 14 of the 2022 Banana Ball World Tour.
All right.
You're a part of the final
destination. Oh, that could be.
Yes. Gabby Guerrero with
home run.
A laser beam.
I was doing, trying not to do Harry Carey there for just a second.
Wow.
I was just about to say, I think that this guy's made for Banana Ball. He's one of my favorite players.
This guy?
Oh, yeah.
You mean you're
he's incredible, man.
So you guys are talent scouting right now, potentially.
Big time.
Yeah, to an extent.
All right.
And his family origin is pretty solid. They know baseball in that family pretty well, and he's been awesome the whole weekend.
How have the Monarchs as a team embraced the idea of this as a exhibition? Were they skeptical at first?
That's what I think. I think, well, more than anything, I think they just had a bunch of questions. Like, what even are we doing right now?
Right.
Was the large part of yesterday. But I've been telling everybody that I thought the coolest part was how quickly they bought in and were like, okay with some of the stuff that everything that we were doing really, and like kind of having really fun with it.
Right.
And not taking it too serious, which I thought was cool, because I was thinking from their perspective, like preseason game, I feel like there's not a better preseason game that you could play to, you
you're
know,
loose,
bond with your
you're
new
having
teammates.
Fun. Yeah. Look, it's the same with my business in acting. You know, you get into it because you want to have fun. You start taking classes, you're doing improv, you're doing all this stuff, and it's fun. Then it becomes a job and work. So when you have the opportunity to reconnect with what originally brought you into the game or into your profession, which is fun,
new spark.
It's good for you, man. It reminds you that you are, at the end of the day, playing a kid's game and having a good time doing it. So.
And I think it helps. I mean, if they can be comfortable in this environment, then any of the games that they're going to play going forward this next season should be a breeze.
100%.
So that's been really cool.
Big City Matt Adams in the box. DH for the Monarchs.
Matt Adams?
Yeah, he's as bought in as anybody here. That's Matt Adams.
Okay.
World Series champion a few years ago with.
That's a potential going deep caught.
Yeah, it was very high. But
that was good. That was a very good call there. Yeah. I like that.
That was a very major league height hit.
Yeah.
Very high in the sky. Almost took out the drone, folks. ESPN's drone almost went down on a Matt Adam pop-up.
What a
headline that
would've is. Would have been worth it, honestly.
Yeah. ESPN's, they got deep pockets. They could get another drone.
Tanner Thomas hauls it in. And now it will be Yan Hernandez, the right fielder.
Wait, who did Matt Adams win a World Series with?
The Washington Nationals.
Yes! That Matt Adams.
Right, because he was a
Wasn't he a Dodger?
Oh, geez. I don't think he was ever a Dodger. That one's going to hang up in Breland Almodova.
Oh, what a catch.
A little something extra on that one. Nice slide and catch for dramatic effect.
And now he's laying down.
Now he's going to play to the crowd. Somebody's going to get a ball out there and left.
I don't know if he's going to be able to find anybody.
This might take forever.
All right, fellas.
It's pretty easy.
This has been fun.
Hey, Eric, thank you so much.
Thanks,
you
got to
get out there. Experience
Hey
this
Baby. Is so
this
fun.
Is,
this
unique.
Is Hey Baby?
Yeah. Hey Baby time.
Really nice
good job,
you.
Guys. This is really fun.
Enjoy the rest of the game.
Enjoy your time in doing this. You could be digging holes. Remember that.
It's fact.
This is better than that.
That's very good.
More.
All right.
There goes Eric Stone Street, star from Modern Family, and the Kansas City native who has been having a blast here tonight. And it's really – really great to hear it.
Now
we will. Yeah.
Okay.
I know
you're going to be upset. Hey Baby's going on. I know you get lonely.
And you're
going to have
me
to
as
leave
well.
You too.
Well, now
you're
going
to have to go solo. I've got some prior things that I signed up for that I've got to take care of.
Yeah,
I mean,
TV
we are here for the show.
Leaves,
we are here for the show.
And you abandoned me right
some
after.
Some would say I'm a TV superstar too as well, so.
Yeah,
I'm just kidding.
No. On the interwebs, you're
you
a superstar,
go.
Buddy.
There you go.
The DMs are all,
but,
all you need for that.
It was a blast. Thank you for having me, as always.
Thank you, my dear friend.
Cannot wait to see you in the later evening.
Hey, No doubt about that. There goes Kyle Lewix. I'm going to turn it down to the field for the end of Hey Baby. So much. I'm happy that you and your 2,096 friends here on YouTube are still with me. Thank you to everybody watching on the No Filter Network as well. We're fired up to be broadcasting on multiple websites. That's how big this thing's gotten. Eric Stone Street, star of Modern Family, and Kyle Lewix, star of the Savannah Bananas, both abandoned me in the booth. And the Bananas will look to avoid dropping this inning as Gabby Guerrero lined a laser beam over the high wall and left for a solo shot, giving the Monarchs a 1-0 inning lead. Bananas currently leading the ball game, 2 points to nothing. That's the all important points category, of course. And it's gonna be 3-4-5 in the Bananas order. Fourth pitcher on the mound in as many innings for the Monarchs. Jordan Martinson will come on in and replace Jacob Lindgren. And here comes the young professor.
Kansas City making his way to the plate. He is a 2-time World Series champion, including one right here in Kansas City. Give it up for number 28, Johnny Gomes!
Johnny 0-for-1 on the night, bounced out to third. Dan Oberst on deck, Andrew Don in the hole. And that's a hot shot, bodied by David Thompson over at third base, across the diamond, and that's gonna go over the head of Casey Gillespie. Johnny Gomes with his first hit as a Savannah Banana. That ball was scorched. Really all Thompson could do was put his chest on it. Just got a squeeze of the keister, and I turn around and Christina from ESPN is the only person I see. It was Michael. Let the record know, let the record show. It was Michael Galinsky who got a good chunk of my right buttocks. And speaking of real good buttocks, Danny Oberst with a hot shot through the left side of the infield. He's 2-for-2 on the day. He walked off the first inning driving in Tanner Thomas with a shot to the left center field gap. The inning tying run on second base. The inning winning run on first. And the Bananas third baseman takes that breaking ball. Bit up and out. Strikeout swinging for Donnie, his first trip to the dish. Makes him 2-for-3 in the Challenger Series here in Kansas City. That is a beautiful bender in there for strike two. Martinson trying to secure the first inning win for the Monarchs tonight. That one grounded to third. Thompson steps on the bag, won't have a play. His third base counterpart digging down the line. Andrew Don's got good wheels. So Johnny Gomes eliminated from the base paths. Danny Oberst takes second on the fielder's choice. And now Dalton Cornett, the shortstop, one for one with the double on the night. We'll try and bring in the speedy Dan Obers from second. That one fouled straight back. Dalton lined one right down the left field line. Just barely fair. Avoiding the chalk. By just about, half an inch on the right side of it. Now an 0-2 pitch, lefty on lefty. That one looped foul, third base side. Davidson doesn't have room, and the fans not able to make a play. It clanks off the hands of a couple folks out there. DC with new life. Martinson, the man on the mound, at the Los Angeles Dodgers organization. Out of North Richland Hills, Texas, made it all the way up to AAA. That one bounced softly to second. Don, did he avoid the tag? I don't think so. Heck of a play there. Darnell Sweeney skims the tush. A lot of Keister talk here on the broadcast tonight. More than normal. And the Monarchs win the inning. It is now 2-1 with the Bananas on top. And as you take a look at that one, looks like it just barely got him. You can see Andrew Don felt it too. We will turn it down to the man in the yellow tux, Jesse Cole, for a little banana in the pants.
To catch some bananas in the pants.
Okay, you're on that side. And the first time ever out of the berm, we have Tanner Thomas. And he's throwing out the name of the game as we're gonna throw these bananas. And whoever catches the most in the pants is the winner. Your guy in front of you is representing your section, so we gotta get loud. Tanner Thomas, you start in the outfield. All right, Malachi, what do you got?
Let's go, Malachi. Flash the kid, let's it rip.
Here we go.
One in the pants.
Oh, well. Oh. All right, keep it going.
All right, Malachi, Tanner. Let's go. Let's make it two. Two for two, right over here. Over here, up top.
All right.
Let it rip. Boom, in the pants. It's doubled up digits.
Come on, Will.
Let's go for the hat trick. Let's go, Malachi. Here it goes. It's up.
There we go.
Just a bit outside.
Come on, Will. Yeah.
Oh, he's got one. Let's go, our last. Let's go. Oh, that's three! Give him a four-piece and a biscuit. Let's go. The whole bunch. Oh! Give him the kill shot, Malachi. Give him the kill shot. Boom! On the first base side.
Wow, Malachi Mitchell with his man in the red shirt, victorious on the right field side. Tanner Thomas and Jesse Cole, not as successful in right field and on the third base side, respectively. David Moore, the new man on the mound for the Bananas, replacing Emmanuel Rosario, who goes one inning, one run earned, ends up losing the inning because of the solo home run off the bat of Gabby Guerrero. 94 miles per hour in, had to be triple digits off the bat. The eye radar that I've got, a little gun in my brain, says it was about 112 miles per hour off the bat, something like that. Casey Gillespie, the first baseman, with a hard ground ball single and ate up Dan Oberst over at first base so far on the evening for the three-year Kansas City Monarch. That would be counting 2022 as year three. Man out of the Tampa Bay Rays and Chicago White Sox organizations. Pride of Pittsville, Wisconsin. That one outside, Casey's gonna take first.
The last we can go is
and tough to have a wild pitch on the sprint. The Bananas now get into their seventh and final fielder that needed to touch the ball to make it live. Breland Domadova, the left fielder. Trying to pull a fast one on Gillespie. No luck over there at third base. It'll be a three-base sprint. And this has been the bugaboo of David Moore. He was a party animal for the World Tour. A Mercer product, University of Pittsburgh before that. He's got as good of stuff as anybody on the Bananas pitching staff. It's a matter of control that has been his problem. And that one misses high, five straight balls to start off the inning. Bananas bringing the infield in. Nice job getting the outside corner. David Thompson, the third baseman for the Monarchs, bounced out to his counterpart. It was a heck of a play from Andrew Don. That one hit high and far to left field, and you can kiss that puppy goodbye way out of here. A two-run jack off the bat of David Thompson. Out into the parking lot. Cars beware, that was a dangerous shot. The former New York Mets product did not miss the fastball from David Moore. A little shrug of the shoulders. And after winning their first inning of the evening, taking the fourth inning 1-0, they start off the fifth inning 2-0. Now the catcher, J.C. Ascara. Front door breaking ball comes in high. Gabby Guerrero last frame. David Thompson this inning. As the Monarchs have found the power, the first two home runs hit for either side in the Challenger Series. And Moore having problem with the zone once again. Ascara 1-for-1 on the day, a double and a run scored. And four straight bad ones. The Bananas with that terrific sprint defense. Ascara's in trouble at second. Almodova with the tag, he's out. That is sprint defense to a T. Textbook from the Nanners. Defense coming up huge for David Moore. Two sprints and a two-run home run, but he gets an out on this one. As you see on the replay, Breland right there to apply the tag. And now it'll be the center fielder, Willie Abreu. Bounced out to first, his first trip to the dish. Was ready for a front door breaking ball, serves that one into right for a base knock. Couple barrels now from the Monarchs here in the top of the fifth inning. Action in the Bananas bullpen, stretching going on out there. Still a handful of arms that could be used. Breaking ball misses high to the shortstop and 10 hitter, Kevin Santa. Sack fly to right his first time up. And this is where it gets dangerous for David Moore. Santa lets the front door breaking ball go, but David so far has not been ahead of any of these five hitters that the Monarchs have trotted up to the dish. That one misses the inside corner. A chirp from the crowd. They thought it was a good inside pitch. Sure, Vincent Chapman will take that into account. David Moore walks his third batter of the frame. Nanners once again playing the sprint defense perfectly, and holding up at third base is Willie Abreu. Santa will be content with one base on his walk, just like it's baseball. And a brief meeting on the mound. Breland Almodova all the way in from left field. With some words of encouragement, Dalton Cornett, the shortstop, joins the meeting on the bump. Brief, because mound visits are illegal. That's just we're handing the ball back to you, and a couple words of encouragement. Monarch's batting order turned on its head. Darnell Sweeney, a switch hitter, turns around to hit from the right side for the first time in the Challenger Series. 0-for-2 with a strikeout and a pop out to third in foul territory tonight. Runners on the corners with one down. And Moore will check on Santa over at first. Abreu leads off third. The Monarchs with two runs already in the frame on the no-doubt two-run blast off the bat of David Thompson. Breaking balls high, Bill Leroy tries over at first, and Santa back just in time. Kevin over at first base, a Seattle Mariners product, made it all the way up to AAA. In Tacoma. And that's gonna be ball four. Four sprints so far here in the fifth inning. The Bananas once again playing the defense. Great, a play at second, he's out! Darnell Sweeney's got great wheels, but Breland Almodova with his second tag out of the inning on second. A little butt-bouncing celebration. Theme of this game so far tonight has been a whole lot of tookus action.
The world's tallest pitcher. Please welcome Dakota.
My goodness, pandemonium here in the top of the fifth. The Monarchs have three runs in. Willie Abreu scored on the RBI base on balls there by Darnell Sweeney, who was then thrown out at second. Kevin Santa made it all the way over to third. And how about this? Pete Cosma, 8 years in Major League Baseball, has faced the best talent that this world has to offer in the baseball department. But nobody coming from the arm slot. Oh my gosh. Of 10 feet, 11 inches. Dakota Allbrin, a banana for the second straight spring. Showed us his very unique stilt talents last February in the original professional banana ball tryout. And he was a no-doubter, getting the crowd going. A favorite of Barstool Sports. Have to let the boys know that their king is back on the bump. We've got a center field camera that surprisingly can fit him. Cosma, the extra hitter for the Monarchs tonight, 0-for-2 with a couple strikeouts, one swinging, one looking. And Albritton fills up the zone with the first pitch. That's the first Monarch who has been behind in a count at the plate so far this inning. That one bounced in the dirt. Good stop though by Bill Leroy. Dakota so far on the tour, only with a third of an inning pitched. He hit a batter and then got a ground out in Golden Park in Columbus, Georgia. This is his toughest task yet though. That one low, racing towards home, and wisely so, Kevin Santa able to score on the wild pitch. Dakota Allbritton. He's got a lot of skill on the stilts, but not the most fleet of foot. So there was nobody home at home plate. And although he tried his darndest, Santa was able to do 90 feet a lot quicker than Albritton was able to do 60. That one down and out, and Cosma ahead in the count 3-1. ...2011 World Series champion, facing a task taller than ever before and doesn't have to take the bat off his shoulders. That's another sprint, and Pete wisely jogs to first, and he'll be content with one bag. The two outs in this inning, both were on sprints. The Bananas have not gotten an out in the field. They've cut down Darnell Sweeney and J.C. Ascara before that, trying to get to second base. Now pinch hitting Joel Booker. He'll come in here for Gabby Guerrero. Guerrero was 1-for-2 with a strikeout and a monster solo shot. And the Columbus, North Carolina native drops a perfect swinging bunt down the third baseline. But look out, let's hope Pete Cosma's okay. He takes a spill, rounding second base. Looks like he's gonna head off the field with nothing wrong with him.
All right, fans, we have a special day coming up. First, we're gonna welcome three Bananas players, Matt Malatesta, Kyle Lewigs, and Alex Ziegler. And now, please welcome on the field their mothers. Come on out, moms. All right, we have Matt Malatesta's mom, Alex Ziegler's mom, and Kyle Lewis's mom. And they're here. As we know, it is a special day tomorrow. So can all the moms please stand up? All the mothers in the house, please stand up. Let's give every mom here a round of applause for everything they do. They deserve a huge round of applause leading into Mother's Day. And now some of the Bananas are gonna be going out handing out roses to those special moms. So if you have a special mom with you right now, give her a hug. Give her a hug if your mom's here. And now let us know, who should we give a rose to? Which mom deserves a rose? Let me hear you out here.
Well, all the moms deserve a rose, Jesse, but I'm not sure we'll have a rose for all the moms. I might get vicious in the stands. Hopefully everybody can be understanding of that. Wow, that's my word for the top of the fifth inning. The Monarchs pushed four runs across on three hits and five walks. And there was two of the outs of the inning were on two of the walks. Sprints that ended with a tag out, the glove of Breland Almodovar at second base. And the third out was an infield single. Pete Cosma took a spill rounding second base. And now we head to the bottom of the fifth inning. The Bananas have their work cut out for them. It'll take four runs to tie the inning, five runs to win it. They've scored four runs three separate times against the Party Animals on the World Tour, two of them to come back from 3-0 deficits. And how about that? The Cole family with roses delivered to them. They must know somebody in the front office. New man on the mound for the Monarchs is Nick Belzer. And he fires a fastball up and in to a dancing Breland Almodovar. Left fielder for the Bananas bounced out to short. Back in the second inning. Breaking ball inside. And just like that, Breland in the driver's seat. Count now full. The Bondurant Idaho native fires home. Breland's got great speed. Throw from deep third, not in time. Ends up being a wild one off the tarp. And Breland will be content with an infield single. Almost a tremendous play from David Thompson. But the Bananas have exactly what they need, the leadoff man on. Now it'll be Christopher Vasquez, the extra hitter, 0-for-1 on the night with a strikeout. And as Chris steps up to the dish, oh, he bounces one up the middle. That's what happens when he steps up to the dish. A close play at second base. I don't know what Breland Almodova was up to. Almost was thrown out by Willie Abreu. And what I was trying to say is, Christopher was walking up to the plate, is I'm joined in the booth by Malachi Mitchell.
What's up, Nico? You doing all right today, dude?
I am doing superb, my dear friend. Flash the Kid joining us before he heads off to Austria in about, what, 2.5 weeks?
2.5 weeks, May 23rd.
How absurd is that? Now, Dalton Malden in the box.
Walking up to his own song and Breland sitting down at second base. Who would have thought?
There's always about four things that I want to be talking about at once, at any given moment here in Bananaland. Well, Feliz Navidad getting pelted out of the place. Dalton was plunked right off that tookus of his, ended up scoring what was the inning tying run in the third. And loops that one towards center. Racing in Abreu, he'll catch it on the fly and fire in for the first out of the frame. So, Malachi,
what's up, Nico?
This is your third journey here with the Bananas. The premier team last year, the Breakfast Bowl team this past summer.
Yes, sir.
And now your second run playing banana ball in what we call the Spring Series, now the Banana Ball World Tour. What has this journey been like for you, buddy?
Dude, it's been absolutely insane just to see the talent that we have out here, all the guys we've been playing with. Eric Burns stepping into the box.
I think
who would have thought?
Now pinch hitting the manager and one of the Oakland A's all-time greats, please welcome Eric Burns.
Audibles all over the place, so Jacob Teston more than happy to give up the lumber to his skipper. The 11-year MLB vet, Eric Burns. Time spent with the A's, Orioles, Rockies, Diamondbacks, and Mariners. Takes a good hack at it. Could be caught by a fan, but it falls safely to the floor.
Looks like Burns is sweating a little bit right now.
I don't think we would have heard louder boos from the crowd if Eric Burns popped out to a fan on the first swing of his at-bat.
Dude, 10,000%, and I'm pretty sure Burns would have walked into the stands.
No, that's a little floater
he
down the
ball.
Right field line. It's going to fall foul. Burns racing towards second, but clearly about a foot to the wrong side of the line, in my estimation.
I'm going to give Burnsy this clutch hit right here. I promise. It's coming. Looks like he was swinging it good in BP this morning. Fouling off a couple good pitches right now. Burnsy's looking a little hot.
And there's the proof that it was a couple feet into foul territory. Burnsy's one at-bat so far on the World Tour was a momentous one in Birmingham, Alabama, the oldest stadium in this country, Rickwood Field. He had the tying run on third base for the ball game, and Sean Fluke got him on that nasty 12-6 hook. Struck out swinging.
Fluke will sneak that 12-6 by you. You got to watch out.
That's a fact. He's able to watch that bender float outside of the zone. Now 1-2 on the Bananas manager. Lights that one into left center field. It's a base hit. Breland Almodova racing home. He will score, and into third base goes Vazzy. Eric Burns with a ribeye, and officially batting 500 as a Savannah Banana.
As he shows off the Banana Dolce Cabana undies. What did I say? I told you it was coming.
Nostradamus from you, buddy.
There we go. I learned it from Bill Leroy himself as he walks up to the plate. Let's go.
So just like that, the Bananas have the inning tying run in the box. Vasquez leads off third, Burns leads off first. Both of them can run well. Bill Leroy has two career home runs as a Banana. One in Macon, an old Luther Willard Field, and one at home in Grayson in the second game of the World Tour this spring.
What are the odds Burnsy rips one right here?
Oh, Bill Leroy! Leroy! Deep to left field! That one's
Did you?
Way out of here!
No way, Bill!
The inning's tied 4-4!
Woo!
His second home run of the tour!
The man, the myth, the legend! Bill Leroy himself, Lord have mercy!
Oh, he's found his power as a professional Banana!
I tell you what, Biko, I don't think I'm leaving the broadcast booth. Same seats on the bus.
I don't think we're going to let you leave either, Malachi. Eric Burns lifts his captain into the sky, and in the blink of an eye, this inning is locked at 4 runs apiece.
Party in the booth.
Take a look at this one. Fastball right down Broadway, and Bill didn't miss it, Malachi.
Got every single lace of that ball, and then some. Pick it up on the way back to Savannah.
Wowza, how the turntables. Unreal. Almodova, Vasquez, and Burns have all come in to score. Bill behind him, now Tanner Thomas skies one in the infield. Who's gonna grab it? Oh no, it falls to the ground, and Tanner didn't take a step out of the batter's box, so he's out at first.
Uh-oh. That's a blank right there, Tanner. It's okay, boy.
A tough one for the 2018 and 2019 Banana. Let's give it up to Shark here.
Right here in Kansas City. Make some noise for number 28, Johnny Gomes.
Johnny Gomes with his third AB of the night, sixth in his young Banana's career. Hot shot up the middle.
Attaboy, Johnny.
Past the diving attempt of Kevin Santa. And Johnny Gomes, 2-for-3 on the night.
Look at that. He's turned it around since yesterday. I tell you what, his BP rounds today were absolutely phenomenal. Absolutely lacing the ball. Exit velo. Over 3 digits.
Well, it's understandable when you haven't played professional baseball since 2016 that it might take you a day or two to get your sea legs under you.
100%. Now Dan Oberst in the box, hot like a sauna.
That's a tapper towards the mound. And Nick will fire it over to first in time. So the Bananas avoid the Monarchs getting to tie this game at 2 points apiece. A 4-run frame out of nowhere. Singles from Almodova, Vasquez, and Burns before the big blast off the bat of Bill Leroy. We'll turn it down to the young professor for a little derby race on Derby Day.
Derby, so we wanted to treat you this evening to the Kansas City Derby right here at Legends Field. So let's go ahead and we will meet our jockeys and our horses. So first up, here on the outside, please welcome Heather and her faithful steed, Chris. Over here to my left, this is Heidi and her faithful steed, David. My third team, this is Kelly and her faithful steed, Pat. And the owner of the Kansas City Monarchs, give it up for Valerie and her faithful steed, Mark Brynmeyer. All right, horses in position. On your mark, get set, go! They are off to the races. and get to an early lead is Heather and Chris. Our Steve Chris, he is going for broke. He is looking to make it. He is rounding third. This is going to be close. They are running away with it. That is a thoroughbred right here. The other horses are falling far, far behind. Giddy up, giddy up. Coming on down. Going to the finish line. Here they go, here they go. Without question, the winner of the Kansas City Derby, Jennifer Heather and her faithful steed, Chris.
Well, always a blast here in Kansas City when you get a two derbies for the price of one. I gotta be honest, I've got a bone to pick with Heather and Steve. Heather was not on top of Steve as the other three contestants were, as they should be. So I'm gonna put an asterisk next to that victory. And
maybe slight disqualification. We'll have to talk with the Olympic
committee
about that one.
Yeah, the rules experts are gonna have a lot of questions here tonight. And, speaking of a lot of questions, Malachi, do you have to leave us, my dear friend?
I do have to leave you guys. I'm going to go back down there so I can see if I can catch Bill after this half inning.
Yeah.
Just to give him a big old hug after that bomb he hit.
Hey, needs to happen. I really appreciate you coming up to the booth for the most eventful half inning of the evening.
Yeah, Nico.
Love it. Hey, Malachi, first of all, because it's the last time we'll get to say it, good luck in Austria, my friend.
Yes, sir.
It's been so much fun this past year plus. Three different stints with the Bananas, and I know this is not goodbye. You will be back.
Yes, I will be back.
Plenty of times, but it's going to be really cool seeing what you can do over there in Europe, my man.
Yes, sir. I appreciate you, Biko. I will see you when I get back, man.
There goes Flash the Kid, Malachi Mitchell. And he's already out of the booth. That's how quick he is. I looked over to my right, over to my left, and he was gone. Oh, my gosh. Malachi is as good as they come. A guy who really never got a good shot at it throughout his collegiate career, 4 years at Florida A&M and then one more at Savannah State. He has by far been playing his best baseball in a Bananas uniform. He was 3 for 3, hit 1,000 on the World Tour. 11 for 15 in stolen base attempts, had a couple walks and a sprint to first base as well. Very eventful time in a Bananas uniform. Matt Malatesta, the new man on the mound. Morgan Johan, the new man in the box. So the Monarchs have switched teams here. This is what marks the switching of the rosters. They go from the Kansas City Monarchs, who you will see in the American Association, to the Kansas City Monarchs, who play against the Kansas City Monarchs, who will be in the American Association. A couple balls, scorched foul off the bat of Johan. Basically, the backup Monarchs are the team that trains with the main team a lot. They're a wood bat team. They actually play in about three different leagues here in the general area. Travel all over the Midwest playing baseball. And they come in trailing by a run. Andrew Don never really had a shot at that one. That'll be an infield single for Morgan Johan. Now, it's tricky because basically Johan, it's very tricky. The backup Monarchs are starting at the top of their order, even though it was supposed to be the four hole for the Monarchs. But hey, this is exhibition banana ball. You know, basically anything goes. Wild pitch there, and Johan will take second. Now Alex Lahasky, the second baseman, will try his luck. Matt Malatesta on the mound. He was a collegiate banana this past summer for the final 2 weeks of the year, the most important 2 weeks of the year. As he made himself a legendary banana in such a short amount of time wearing the uniform. That one gets the outside corner. Count one and two on Lahasky, with Johan leading off second. That one knifed foul. Matt threw five innings of one-run ball in his first appearance as a Banana, which was the final regular season game, and then turned in three and two-third innings of scoreless relief in the decisive Game 3 of the Coastal Plain League Championship when the Bananas needed him most. Able to get Lahasky swinging, Bill fires over to Oberst for the first out of the frame. And now it'll be Daryl Graham, the shortstop. Oh my gosh! The triple butt rub right behind home plate. Daryl Graham getting into it with Vincent Chapman and Bill Leroy. And while the dancing was happening, Morgan Johan stole third base. Matt Malatesta asking Seth Strickland, hey, was time called? And Seth said, no, I'm pretty sure we're playing ball here. Whether my compadre was rubbing butts with two fellow men or not, the game was happening. So the Bananas will now have to pinch the infield in after the stolen base. Count even at 1-1 on Graham. Malatesta, a splitter pitcher predominantly. He'll throw a fastball, a forkball, a changeup. He'll spin it once in a while, but he's gonna give you 80 to 85% splitters because the pitch is just that gosh darn good. And it's exactly what you want here with a man on third when you're looking to keep a ground ball in the infield. That was the forkball, ends up below the zone. Count now even at 2-2. Smoked, diving stop Andrew Don, only plays at first, throws a worm burner across the diamond. And Danny Oberst able to field the ground ball on the other end. A snazzy play by Donnie Banana Ball. That ends up being an immense steal of third base by Morgan Johan, because he comes in to score on the play. And credit Graham with an RBI ground out. Now Gilberto Pena, the third baseman, who's catching last night, takes a fastball for a called strike. And that one tapped back to Malatesta under the glove. Charging Cornette, flips to first in time. Monarchs get a run on a hit and nobody left on base. And here's Shark.
Would all members of the United States military, both past and present, please rise? Fans, please join the Bananas in honoring the men and women that serve this great nation as we salute our hometown heroes of the night. The Savannah Bananas thank you for your service and commitment to our great country and for protecting our freedom.
Well, a special moment here in Kansas City. As I send Shark's thoughts from all of us in Bananaland out to everybody watching on YouTube and the No Filter Network. A shot from the Banana Panorama, and now you see, it's a busy booth tonight. I'm joined by the Banana's mascot, Split. And Split normally does not have a ton to say when he joins the booth, but happy to see you got a headset on. Split, your first time in Kansas City, the farthest that the Banana's mascot has ever traveled. How's it been for you here? It's a roller coaster ride of emotions. Hot, yeah, it's been hot, but it's been great. Terrific. That's really good to hear, my dear friend. And you would like to hit a home run. You would like to run around the park. You've been running around the park. You've been all over the place. Delightful. That's very good to hear. That's what you should be doing. You've been drinking your water, your banana juice. Is that cannibalistic? I don't think there is banana juice anyway. Split doesn't care. You eat bananas, Split. Yeah, that's how he gets so strong. No, he doesn't. No, he doesn't. Fake news. That's not true at all. He gets so strong from pumping iron. Yeah, that makes sense. That makes sense. And from staying hydrated. That's good. What are you, like protein powder or something? There's got creatine? There's got to be a secret. Yeah, creatine guy. Nuts. You're not juicing, right? No. Split's not juicing. That'd be the biggest scandal in Bananaland history. That's au naturel. Let me give it a squeeze. Ooh, really good stuff. Powerful. Check out this Split. We've got three Monarchs doing their best Vincent Chapman impersonation. And this has been one of the most fun aspects of this whole Challenger series with the Monarchs is, besides being incredibly gracious hosts and just being fired up for us to come here, they have 100 billion% look it up, mathematically possible, they've 100 billion% just absolutely bought in. And getting to talk to Matt Adams, Gabby Guerrero, a handful of guys before the game today, and Split just absolutely dominates my camera. They had the most fun they basically had in recent memory playing the game last night. Split, I thought you were about to alienate our entire audience. And that, what you just saw, three Monarchs dancing their tails off with the home plate umpire, is what it's all about. It's really what it's all about. And Matt Adams doing the weigh-ins both games. What do you got going on? He's a tall guy. Big city. Wide. Strong like Split. Yeah. Well, not quite as strong as Split. But he's one of the stronger people here. And obviously, Split is as strong as they come. So he's got to go. Split, thank you so much for joining me in the booth. Oh, my God. Where you didn't see it, but he just kissed me right on the mouth. You smell a lot worse than Eric Stone Street, I'll tell you that one, Split. Looks like that one bounced off the hand of Andrew Dodd. Split with a rude gesture to me as he departed the booth. Oh my goodness gracious. So, guy's a riot, but never get much out of him verbally. The Bananas have the inning tying run on base. Donnie was 0 for 2.
Let's go!
And now Dalton Cornett, 1 for 2 with a double, skies that one to left. The new left fielder backpedaling, and Ryan McDill will haul it in. Donnie retreats back to first. Now it'll be Breland Almodova who wanted the camera low, now he wants it high. He's gonna go over the camera. And Bill's coming too. Oh my gosh. I think Nick Keldy's life just flashed before his eyes. Sanders left fielder ready to rock and roll. Bounces that one, foul. It's Matt Stevens on the mound now for the Kansas City Monarchs. 6th pitcher in as many innings. Breland represents the walk-off run for the Bananas. Andrew Don over at first base represents the inning tying run. Just a smidge over 20 minutes left to play as Breland skies that one to shallow left. Gonna be a tough play, no. Stevens once again there to call it in. He'll fire all the way back to first, but Andrew Don with plenty of time to spare. So after the leadoff hit by pitch, a couple flyouts to left, and the Bananas one out away from letting the Monarchs tie this ball game. Vazzy Vasquez, 1 for 2 on the day. Run scored. Chris down to one knee on the breaking ball. Stevens now one strike away from tying this game at 2-2. Don takes off for second, breaking ball's high. Donnie's third steal of the tour. And Vasquez able to fight off the fastball. Another 1-2 offering. And line foul again. Stevens going after the extra hitter for the Bananas. Heaters in the zone on back-to-back pitches. And Chris able to spoil another. You're right about that, Judy P. Banana ball is all about fun. Now the count even at 2 balls and 2 strikes. With 2 down, Andrew Don, the tying run for the inning, leads off second. Vasquez stays alive. Ninth pitch of the at-bat coming. Breaking ball, and it's sky to shallow left. This time it will be the shortstop. Darryl Graham making the play. And the Monarchs win the 6th inning 1-0. They tie the game at 2 points apiece. And here comes Jesse Cole.
Sure, you know we like to dance out here. But we got a challenger here. So this is called Are You a Better Dancer Than a Banana? So we have 10-year-old Eden. Let's hear it for Eden. And we have Banana's pitcher, Colin Ledbetter. So here's how it's gonna work. Player's gonna go, then Eden's gonna go. And we're gonna see who wins. You guys are gonna be the judge. We're doing 3 dances, a dance-off. Let's get a little music, Shark, for Colin. Okay, interesting kick move. All right, you went, go back to the back. All right, not bad. All right, Eden, your turn. Oh!
Ouch.
Okay, very good, Eden, very good. Next dance, what do you got? Oh, all right. All right, a little dolphin dive. I see that. Backwards work, all right. All right, Eden, what do you have? Too well so far. All right, let's try this next one. All right, Colin, what do you got here? Oh, he's gonna try it. Ow!
What?
That looked painful. All right, Eden, last chance to beat Colin, but I think you're doing pretty well. Here we go. Oh, no. Oh.
From Eden. Colin, I love you, buddy, but you never stood a chance. We've got a 2-2 game with 16 minutes to play heading into the top of the 7th inning. Remember, in Banana Ball, once the clock strikes 10 minutes left, we will not start another inning. So for all intents and purposes, this will probably be it. So far tonight, we've had a 2-minute and 5-second inning from Christian Ehrman. That was when he struck out the side in the top of the first. Since then, every inning has been 3 minutes or more. And you can do the math. Doesn't bode well for starting another inning after this one. Lucas Kelly will replace David Moore on the mound. And it's gonna be Brandon DeLynn. The new first baseman for the Monarchs as of an inning ago. Leading it off, lefty on lefty. Lucas Kelly was a party animal throughout the first 12 games of the tour. Man out of Wake Forest, North Carolina. Spent a year at Surrey College and another at Wake Technical Community College before finishing up his collegiate time, just getting his degree. And actually resumed or started his professional career a few years after he left college. He's played for the Portland Mavericks, the Salem Kaiser Volcanoes, the Bakersfield Train Robbers, and the London Majors. It's been a wild past couple years for Kelly as Dan Oberst able to get that one on a couple hops. And he retires the Monarchs first baseman for the first out of the frame. Now it will be the DH, Cam Messerschmidt. My roster says Mark Richard, but this is who I've got. Wow. It's a bad dash in the booth between Shark and I. Trying to make sure that the Monarchs are sticking to their secondary lineup. You never know if they're gonna pinch hit somebody. And it looks like Messerschmidt is wearing Mark Richard's jersey number. You just never know what's gonna happen. Danny Oberst with a fantastic attempt. Oh my goodness. Guy who started his Bananas career back in 2019. By dropping a can of corn pop fly in foul territory. He's come a long, long way. Credits head coach Tyler Gillum for his incredible increase in first base defensive skill. That one tapped to third. Donnie across the diamond in time. Two quick outs for Lucas Kelly.
Fans now coming to pitch. Coming from the crowd behind the Bananas dugouts, please welcome World Series pitcher, Red Sox Hall of Famer, please welcome 75-year-old Bill the Spaceman Lee!
So Lucas Kelly, owner of the fastest inning in the Banana Ball World Tour, the fastest inning in Banana Ball history, gets two extremely quick outs, and now prepares for the legendary Bill Lee to take the ball from him. The 14-year Major League Baseball veteran, 10 of them with the Boston Red Sox, 4 of them with the Montreal Expos. The spaceman himself with a big old kick to the delight of the crowd and gets right down to business. Threw a scoreless inning last night against these Monarchs and touched 78 miles per hour on the gun. And funny enough, the last time Bill Lee was in Kansas City was in 1978. What are the chances of that? Magic just seems to surround the ageless wonder. Throughout the world tour, before his scoreless inning last night, over 8 innings pitched, he gave up 4 runs for a 4.5 ERA, 1 strikeout. That's now his left fielder, Breland Almodova. His victim in the box, Ryan McDill, the left fielder. Bill's not ready for a pitch. He's able to snag it there. I'm not sure what we're waiting for. Close call there. Bill was able to about face just in time to make a play on that. McDill cranks that one foul, count even at 1-1. on our journey to... Oh, what do we have going on here? It's the Bill Lee theme song. 1, 2, 3. I want to be Bill Spaceman, the song says. And that one flown to center field. Easy work for Jacob Teston. Bill Lee and Lucas Kelly combined for a 1-2-3 frame. And here comes Jesse Cole with yellow. Bananas with a chance to walk it off after this.
Pull out your phones. Everybody pull out your phones and your flashlights. Get your flashlights in the air. Everybody here in the stadium, get your flashlights up in the air and your phones. It is time for yellow. We're all going to sing together. Here we go. Let me hear you sing yellow.
Jacob Teston the Banana center fielder to start something here. If the Bananas cannot score a run, we will go to tiebreaker showdowns. So far, only the 2 of 13 games on the World Tour have gone that far. It was games 1 and 3 in Savannah and Daytona, respectively. That one hit to the right center field gap, but with a beat on it and making the snag is Morgan Johan. Bill LeRoy will be the last chance.
Ladies and gentlemen, get those hands together. Number one, Bill LeRoy.
Bill with his legendary entrance. He's had a really nice couple games here in KC. 1 for 2 on the night with a 3-run homer. And the pride of Bananaland, the man out of Dublin, Georgia, behind in the count 0-1. The catcher for the Bananas tonight, captain of this team alongside his partner in crime, Kyle Lewis. And front door breaking ball doesn't have enough bite. Bill ahead in the count. Just like that, Bill in the driver's seat, awaiting a 3-1 pitch. All three of his career Banana home runs. He's been ahead in the count and gotten a fastball to drive. Nothing hittable that time. He's off to the races. The throw goes to short, now to second, third, first, left, center. Bill playing defense, still has to get to right. And there it is. Run for the ball game 180 feet away at second base. Tanner Thomas, the 2018 and 2019 Summer Collegiate Banana, with a chance to send the 6,000 plus fans here home happy. It's a shot to third, and it's booted. Bill's gonna stay at third base though. Gilberto Pena wasn't able to come up with it cleanly. And how about this? Runners on the corners, the winning run at third base.
To third base, everybody on your feet. Now batting for your Bananas, Professor, take it away.
Ladies and gentlemen, now up to bat, number 28, Johnny Gomes!
You couldn't have wrote a better script. The World Series champion here in Kansas City back in 2015. With a chance to walk this one off for the Bananas and even the series at a game apiece. Count 1-1 on the DH for the Bananas, 2 for 3 on the night. Singles in each of his last two trips to the dish. Breaking ball low and in. And Johnny ahead in the count 2-1. That one gets the low outside corner. Slocum one strike away from escaping a jam. The Bananas one run away from winning the game. 2-2 pitch outside, the count runs full. Tanner Thomas will be off for first. That truly doesn't matter. Bill LeRoy on third base is the winning run for the Nanners. Payoff pitch coming to Johnny Gomes. coming home to score is Bill Leroy, and the Bananas win the game 3-2. Johnny Gomes, your hero. Each other up. Congratulations on a heck of a two games. We look down from our eye in the sky, the banana panorama. As the Monarchs win night one, 3-2, and the Bananas return the favor with a 3-2 victory this evening. Wow, what a wild couple nights. Here in Kansas City, Kansas, Legends Field was ablaze with energy. And I'll tell you what, back-to-back sellout crowds, 6,000 plus. Legends Field rocking from the first pitch to the last. This was everything we could have ever asked for. And the first time the Bananas ever played any professional baseball team in our very young sport of banana ball. And there couldn't have been better hosts than the Kansas City Monarchs. As we zoom out above Legends Field, and we conclude the 2022 Banana Ball World Tour. Nanners end up defeating the Party Animals in 8 out of the 12 games, and they split a pair here in Kansas City against the Monarchs. Wow, that was an action-packed night, folks. Thank you for being unreal in the comment section. I would love to spend more time in there myself. There's about 7 things happening each and every second that I want to be talking about. And in the corner of my eye, I can see just absolute madness happening in the comment section. So from all of us here in Bananas TV, we cannot thank you enough. On YouTube, on the No Filter Network, these broadcasts have been just about as fun as it possibly could get. And for that matter, the World Tour was as fun as it possibly could have gotten. Getting on planes for the first time, of course, not yours truly and Kirk Kessler. We drove the Penske. But getting out to the Midwest, crossing the Mississippi, this was the place to do it. And boy, was it done well. So the Bananas end up taking this one 3-2. Christian Dearman, a phenomenal start. 3 shutout innings, struck out the side with the quickest inning of the night, 2 minutes and 5 seconds. The fastest strikeout of the side in banana ball history. Some history there for Christian Dearman, a Hall of Fame banana already in his 4-year career now. And after the Monarchs win 3-2 last night, the Nanners able to strike back with a 3-2 victory this evening. The highlights of the evening. The Bananas took the first inning on a walk-off RBI single from Dan Obers to bring in Tanner Thomas, his 2019 collegiate teammate at that in the summer in Savannah. And then the Bananas jumped out 2-0 on an RBI walk from Tanner Thomas, bringing in Jacob Teston. So it was 2-0 Nanners, and then all of a sudden, the Monarchs stormed back. They were able to get a run in the sixth, a run in the fourth on the Gabby Guerrero solo shot to left, won both of those innings 1-0. And then the fifth inning was when everything went off the rails. David Moore came in, did not have his A stuff tonight, gave up 5 walks and 2 hits, but the Bananas were able to find 2 outs on with their incredible sprint defense and a 3rd out on an infield single where they got Pete Cosmo rounding second base too hard. And even though they pushed 4 runs across, the Bananas responded right back with 4 of their own, highlighted by a Bill Leroy 3-run shot to left field after Matt Davidson had had a 2-run shot of his own in the top half of the frame. So yada yada, that takes us to the 7th inning. It was 2-2 going into that. Lucas Kelly with 2 ground outs. Bill Lee gets a fly out to center. And the rest is history. 2 outs for the Bananas, ends up being a 2-out rally actually. Started up by who else? Bill Leroy works the walk. Tanner Thomas with the infield single. And then Johnny Gomes, the Kansas City Royals legend, 2015 World Series champion right here in this city over at Kauffman Stadium, playing for the big club. He gets the walk-off on the base on balls. 3-2 count blown away. And that does it. The Bananas and Monarchs split the 2-game series. Some big-time thank yous. Of course, I've done it nonstop, but I can't do it enough. Thank you so much, the Kansas City Monarchs. They were so welcoming, so excited to bring us in. And we couldn't have done this broadcast at all with getting the replay and getting wired into some fun Monarchs technology here. It's an A-class ball club, really just tremendous front office, and Dave, and their director of IT, just was a rock star for us on the broadcast side. So thank you to the Monarchs. Thank you to my incredible broadcast team. Takes an army. Emerson Elmgren, my first base camerawoman, back on, check that. Emerson Elmgren, my third base camerawoman, back on the first base camera for the 2nd time in his Bananas broadcast career, the local David Bullard, the drone flyer. Tonight, Patrick McBride flying the Banana Panorama, our eye in the sky. How about Jack Restorfer? Right there, ladies and gentlemen. Approached Nick Keldy, our tremendous roaming cameraman, yesterday. Said, hey, I'm interested in helping out on the broadcast. We said, we've got a spot for you. He ran the scoreboard here tonight. He ran our center field camera. Absolute rock star. So, Jack, welcome to the team, and we are really happy to have you. As I mentioned, Nick Keldy, the best roaming cameraman on either side of the Mississippi, east or west. And then my incredible crew of Chad Reese, the graphics extraordinaire, my coordinating producer, and the man pressing all the right buttons on our tremendous replays, and Griffin Ellis, the technical director, giving you all the best shots for every possible moment of the night, and the brains behind this entire operation technology. It's been an absolute blast. For Jared Orton, the executive producer of Bananas TV, the Kansas City Monarchs once again, all the folks in Bananaland, and most importantly, you great fans watching on YouTube and the No Filter Network, thank you so much. It was an absolute blast these 2 nights in Kansas City. It was an incredible journey throughout this 14-game Banana Ball World Tour. And as Jesse Cole said, we'll be back here in Legends Field in Kansas City once again next year. Let's shut this thing down. We will see you later!